Welcome to the Pro. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbysko and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes. Larry, coming up a two-hour debut on WCW Monday Nitro, and I know that you are looking forward to the Great American Bash, in which Ric Flair and Arn Anderson face Steve Mongo, McMichael, and Kevin Green.
You know, of course I'm on Nitro now. In fact, when I was there, you know, all the controversy, I could put an end to all this. Steve McMichael's wife does have a crush on Ric Flair. She was there in the audience. When I walked by, she started winking at me just because the big dummy's hiding out trying to, you know, get ready for the big match. McMichael's Green, you people don't have a chance.
Well, Dusty, as usual, Larry Zbysko has his own unique interpretation of events.
Well, I tell you what, Christopher Cruz, today on WCW Pro, this morning on TBS, we will discuss all these things about football player, about wrestlers, about Stinger, about the situation with the Steiner, Regal making a challenge. The Great American Bash right around the corner. No other place to be than Saturday morning right here on TBS, WCW Pro. Let me tell you something, Larry Zbysko. Them two boys I'm talking about, football, if you will, they ready for Freddie Jack, and Freddie's ready for them. It's going to be a great hour because I'm contradicting a lot of things you're seeing.
All right, indeed. Sting is going to be in action this hour as well. And now we take you to the ring on the floor. And you hear the music that can only signify the entrance of the former teenage sensation, Das Wunderkind Alex Wright. And there he is. Great kid. And he has really, really developed in the past couple of years here in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, Christopher Cruz, I got to give kudos where kudos are given. You know what I'm talking about. I would like to take my hat off to our colleague, the legendary Larry Zbysko, who opened up this past Monday Nitro with reckless abandon. Still sticking to the point, though, that Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green don't stand a chance against Arn Anderson and Ric Flair. I'm going to get into that a little longer, a little later into the Pro Show this morning.
Well, you know, it's hard to be humble when you're so great.
And speaking of this past WCW Monday Nitro, fans, on behalf of everyone here at World Championship Wrestling, we do sincerely apologize for a couple of occurrences during Nitro. They were circumstances beyond our control, and we hope that you will accept the apology of World Championship Wrestling. Now the collar and elbow tie up, and Alex Wright is shoved back into the turnbuckle. Manny Fernandez is ready for this young man.
Yeah, he's ready. He wants victory here. This is a big step up for Manny Fernandez, and he's not going to apologize to anybody. Alex Wright better be on his toes, better start getting aggressive now that, he's not a teenage pimply kind of kid anymore.
Teenage sensation.
Whatever.
Teenage sensation. You know, speaking of Nitro, the Giant Dusty will be in action this coming Monday night, 2 hours live from Asheville, North Carolina, defending the WCW World Heavyweight Championship.
Well, we're taking a look at the wonderkid, and Larry the Legend Zbysko did talk about the situation with him not no longer being a teenager, knowing when to put guys away, knowing what a victory means to a guy here on WCW Pro right here on TBS this morning. And the other line along them things right here. You talk about news of Nitro coming up, not only the Great American Bash around the corner, I'm going to talk about that, but I know you've got some big news. Can I let out just a little bit of it right now?
I'll go sink in the fleet.
From a world tag team champion, going to be at Nitro this weekend. They haven't been here for a while. I ain't going to say because I know that's your thing, but I just want the people to understand that.
Two of the most popular wrestlers ever in World Championship Wrestling. Indeed,
you know what? They're wrestling Arn Anderson and Ric Flair.
Oh,
they're gonna have about as much of a chance as Dumbo McMichaels and Kevin Green.
Stop it.
That's coming up live and only on pay-per-view at the Great American Bash. You gotta wonder, what if Kevin Green and Steve Mongo McMichael defeat Ric Flair and Arn Anderson at the Bash? How will Flair and Anderson feel then?
Well, I tell you what, they have an opportunity to do it. The athletes of today, and these guys are in top shape. Top form, wrestler that I am, Larry, you're right. And wrestlers in the past, I only seen two guys that really took their careers in wrestling after football. One was the legendary Wahoo McDaniel and the big cat Ernie Ladd. The rest of the guys fell by the way as far as football players go.
Yeah, but look at there was Alex Karras. He thought he was tough.
One time.
Dick the Bruiser had him crying like a baby. He would never get near a ring again. And who was the other jerk?
Yeah, yeah.
No, that was another jerk.
Yeah, well.
Dick Butkus.
Yeah.
He tried it, and he got sent back to the showers crying like a baby.
Well, time will tell. These guys are working hard. Mongo, my Michael, oh. My man, my homie, they ready. And you see Manny Fernandez right here taking the best of young Alex Wright.
Yeah, he's going to have a 19-year-old the cap in his mouth after that one.
I had a chance as well to speak to the legendary Manny Fernandez, who is wondering how this young man has the gall to use that name. I said, it's his name. That's what he's doing.
There's no legendary Manny Fernandez.
Manny Fernandez, the former WCW, one half of the tag team champions of the world.
And who was his partner?
I do not know.
When Matt can read
Dusty Rhodes. I knew it. A version of a reverse chin lock there on Alex Wright by Manny Fernandez.
Almost a chokehold there. You got to have that arm up a little bit more.
Oh, man.
That's close, but if Manny can get away with it, he's going to keep the pressure on Alex Wright here.
Another surprise. We're going to see the debut of two young wrestlers here in World Championship Wrestling this very hour, one of whom is a former Olympic medalist.
Yeah, and I tell you what, and I know that he's been training hard. I've seen some tapes of this young man. And he's got a lot to learn, but a real special look at a former Olympian, if you will, right here on the pro.
Well, what weight did he wrestle at in the Olympics?
In fact, he's a former bobsledding champion.
Bobsledding?
Bobsledding has been working out at the power plant, WCW's school for up-and-coming young wrestlers.
You mean this kid's just sat in a go-kart?
One, two, and I don't think it was quite that way.
And went down a hill full of ice. That's his big claim to fame.
Why did
he's
I ever
gonna
say
have
it?
A rude awakening.
I'll tell you something else that came out of you talking about the power plant. They took a big step this past Monday Nitro when hardworking Bobby Walker took a victory for the power plant, if you will, and himself right there on Nitro with the legendary Larry Zbyszko was also there with the silver tongue, Tony Schiavone.
Yeah, in fact, a big upset for hard work Bobby Walker on Nitro. Now Alex Wright slamming his elbow. Oh, what was that? A headbutt, I think, on Fernandez. Hurt the lower part of his back. A whole lot coming up tonight on WCW Saturday Night. We'll be telling you about that, as well as more about the Great American Bash. Oh, man, those European forearm uppercuts. Both Alex Wright and Lord Steven Regal traded those uppercuts in their recent match at World Championship Wrestling. Now the whip, and Alex Wright with an elbow.
Alex Wright, I mean, tall kid, about 6'3". He can bring that arm up. He's learned how to use the momentum well. Right there, nice snap. Kind of close to the rope, though. Where's he going?
He's going to go up top here. I want to hit high-risk maneuvers. Don't want to miss this thing. Too much at stake right here this morning on the pro. Whoa!
Bang! Over and slam. Not a whole lot of weight behind that. One, two, and...
He took too long. He was too close to the rope. Oh, he got him right smack in the jaw.
Well, he's out now. He's out cold there. Moving around just... This is not even rigor mortis. This is just moving around out of reflexes.
Oh, and a beautiful suplex from the waist lock. One, two, and three in a bridge. Alex Wright victorious over Manny Fernandez as we kick off WCW Pro this morning here on TBS. Still to come, we're going to see, as we said, two debuting young men here in World Championship Wrestling, one of whom is a former Olympic medalist. We'll see Sting in action and a whole lot more in a moment here on the Pro. 2 hour Monday Nitro full of surprises. We take you now to highlights from this past week's WCW Monday Nitro.
Bunches of friends.
Tremendous action from WCW Monday Nitro as we saw one half of the head of Shark being shaved, and then a real sad occurrence. Lex Luger and Sting, well, in a real battle with the Steiner brothers, and it looks like there's some bad blood where there wasn't before.
But you know something, Chris Cruz, that thing turned into, electricity happened in the past Nitro. Sting and Scott Steiner really getting it on, and the situation was brought about by Lex Luger.
Yep.
And the other Steiner come out, the dog come out, and things broke loose. And I tell you what, guys, these two guys now are enemies, brother, because they are at each other's throat. I talk about these two teams.
Hey, all Lex Luger did was help Scott Steiner back in the ring to keep it inside the ring so Sting and Steiner would not get hurt outside. And, of course, the dog-faced gremlin, as goofy as he is, just took everything wrong and blew everything out of proportion.
Well, it's now the sign for this Monday night. Monday Nitro live on TNT for 2 hours beginning at 8 Eastern. It is Lex Luger and Sting against the Steiner brothers in what was going to be a match of friends against friends, now enemies. Now enemies.
Yeah, and the John would defend the world's heavyweight title. You know, Luger is in a situation to wrestle for the world's heavyweight title. And Luger put himself in that situation by being, as I have said on numerous occasions, Larry, I read it different. He is a snake in the grass, and Sting's got to realize that.
Now, you're spreading rumors. And, you know, that's what's responsible for messing Sting's attitude up. Luger's proven himself to be nothing but trustworthy.
Now, Pat Tanaka with two chops to the throat there on Chip Mitten. Chip is the former Winter Olympic medalist in bobsledding for, of course, the United States.
I got an idea. Why don't we team him up with McMichaels and Green? They can all hop in a bobsled, take off down the hill before Anderson and Flair stretch the heck out of them.
Well, the modern-day athlete, when we talk about football players, we talk about one Kevin Green, tremendous athlete, very active in what he's doing, and Michael McMichaels keeps himself in tremendous shape. It will be a war, my friend, coming up at the Great American Bash from Baltimore, Maryland on Father's Day. And guarantee, you know, you say what you want to, Larry, these two guys are gearing up for a fight.
You know, you talk about what if Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green are able to defeat Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. Well, another what if. What if Lex Luger defeats the Giant for the World Heavyweight Championship? What is Sting going to think at that point, now that Sting thinks maybe something happened there when he faced the Giant when that megaphone hit him?
Well, maybe it'll wake him up.
Maybe it will.
And who cares what Sting thinks? It will be Lex Luger's victory.
A cruiserweight title on the line, Rey Mysterio Jr. So much has been heard about him. He's going to face the cruiserweight champion, Dean Malenko. And look at the Great American Bash. And, of course, Falls Count Anywhere. Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster, against Chris Benoit. What if they go up in the concession stand? Who knows what's going to happen
at
the
matter.
Great American Bash.
Falls Count Anywhere. That's right up the Taskmaster's alley. Could happen in the Dungeon of Doom.
And Tanaka flies.
He nailed this, Chip Mitten. Bobsleds can't fight back, kid. You're in a different sport here.
I tell you what, this is a fine-looking young athlete. He's got a way to go, got a lot to learn right here, but he's in there with a guy that is devastating when he wants to be or he gets an opening. I'm talking about one Pat Tanaka. Very schooled in the art of self-defense, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, not a very big guy, gives away some size, but Tanaka extremely sneaky in there.
And he has got, looks like, a couple of handfuls of hair. Now another chop to the throat. A wide open Chip Mitten. Indeed.
Chip Mitten, it sounds like you're calling a match for my three sons. Boy, he used his momentum there. Just sent Tanaka sailing.
It was like somebody tripped him. It was like there was somebody over there that wasn't over there. It was like a ghost tripping and knocked him right on his head. He was thrown with so much power into that turnbuckle. Showing power right here. Could this be another upset for the power plant?
Oh, a beautiful drop kick from the standing position. And he does it again, Chip Mitten. What a tremendous showing this is for the Olympic medalist. Up and does it again a third time. Wow.
Well, he's got to get him in a position, Larry, as you know, to pin him and cover him. And
yeah,
I don't know if that's going to do it.
Not there.
Well, he didn't know where he was. He got discombobulated from the middle of the ring.
A good look at the fans who are jam-packed the Pro Arena. Here at Disney MGM Studios. No.
Didn't come out.
Jumps up.
Oh! He nailed this kid. He's out.
Welcome to where the big boys play.
Get the bobsled or the gurney. Chip Mitten's going to need some help getting out of the ring after that. Thrust kick to the throat.
Forget the bobsled. Just send this kid downhill on a gurney. Same thing.
A whole lot more action to come here on WCW Pro on TBS. We're back in the control center heading for Baltimore and the Great American Bash Sunday, June 16th at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, and available only on pay-per-view. With summer coming here to America, you can feel the temperature starting to rise at World Championship Wrestling. In the much-talked-about title match for the WCW heavyweight title, champion, the Giant, defends against the total package, Lex Luger. Here's one that unfolded before our very eyes. Former Chicago Bear All-Pro defensive tackle Steve McMichael, also known as Mongo. Mongo has taken Carolina Panther All-Pro outside linebacker Kevin Green to be his partner. They collectively will meet Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. Flair got the attention of McMichael by taking visual liberty, shall we say, gentlemen, with his beautiful wife, Deborah. Would you say that? Yes. And another thing, in my estimation, I think that ancient boy Ric Flair is getting a little bit greedy. I mean, Elizabeth, woman, and now Deborah McMichael. Is that too much? Well, I think we have a consensus opinion here. Balls to count anywhere when the Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan meets Chris Benoit. These two men did not get along well in the Lethal Lottery at Slamboree. And the Lord of the Ring, again to be determined, but this time in singles competition as Diamond Dallas Page squares off against Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Of course, we're going to be having more news regarding the Great American Bash later on in this television program. It's the Great American Bash, Sunday, June 16th at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. We're going to be live from Baltimore, Maryland, the arena downtown there in the harbor. And, of course, it's available only on pay-per-view, unless you would join us live in Baltimore. But one way or another, it is a must-see. So get on the horn right now. Call to ensure availability for the Great American Bash. What else?
Great American Bash Control Center. Just now, it is the Giant defending the World Heavyweight Championship against Lex Luger. Imagine if Lex Luger wins, he's going to be wearing three belts. Is that physically possible? The World Television title, one half of the World Tag Team Championship, and of course, the World Heavyweight Championship.
You know, they say third time's the charm. Lex Luger, genetic wonder that he is, definitely could carry the load of three belts. I think the intrigue around the whole championship situation is, what is the position of Jimmy Hart?
Well, Dusty, never in the history has that been done. I think you would know that. Have three belts been worn at the same time?
No, and if there's one guy that is perched to do that, is one Lex Luger. Put himself in a position with Jimmy Hart, taking the grasp whether Jimmy Hart is with him or not, with the Giant situation is Lex Luger faced with becoming World Heavyweight Champion, having them three titles. You know, one thing that erupted on this past Monday night was the situation of the head-shaving situation with Big Bubba, if you will, and the Shark. Right in the midst of all this Great American Bash talk, right in the midst of all this Nitro talk, right in the midst of the Sting Steiner Nitro matchup return, comes this thing on Saturday night that I believe is big time, big brother. I'm talking about explosion. When you take some person off of you, you know what I mean? Hair, or you take something from somebody that is personal, I mean, it becomes personal. I think it will with the Shark and Bubba.
Well, it's a humiliation factor that goes, you know, back, you know, almost a century in professional wrestling when a guy took his hand and messed up your hair. It was an insult. When they slapped your face, it was an insult. But what's wrong with Big Bubba? I mean, to personally insult a man, do it to a little guy. Why do it to the Shark?
In addition to that matchup, we're going to see Ric Flair and Arn Anderson in tag team competition tonight.
Shaving off the hair of the Disco Inferno, that would be two things, a little guy, and that would be an insult. See if this guy is into his hair.
Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, as we said, tonight on WCW Saturday night.
Maybe I shouldn't have given any ideas.
As they get ready for Nitro, the second week of a two-hour Nitro, 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time on TNT, and they are going to face the returning former World Tag Team Champions. What a surprise that's going to be. You're not going to believe it. We'll tell you about it a little bit later in the hour. And Disco Inferno now tries to tag up with Billy Kidman.
Billy Kidman, another kid from the power plant, trying to make his name. All them guys, I'm going to tell you what it does for you. When you see somebody that pulled the upset, if you will, as hardworking Bobby Walker did on this past night show, when you see somebody do that, and you've been down in that power plant for 9, 10, 11, 12 hours a day, and you've been a sweating, you've been a learning your trade, and you've been waiting to get on right here on TBS, right here where WCW is, where the big boys play. That opportunity is unbelievable. His adrenaline's got to really be flowing right now.
Yeah, a lot of butterflies in his stomach, too, which means it'll lead to mass confusion for this kid. Kidman giving away a lot of size to Disco, who thinks about his hair too much, but has good movement. Hey!
Making a good movement there, the scissors, and Billy Kidman looking great against the Disco Inferno. You know, we've talked a lot about Big Bubba shaving half of the head of the Shark. What if on this coming Monday Nitro, the giant surprise opponent is indeed the Shark, and he comes out with half his head still shaved? Is the giant going to want to face a man of 500 pounds, that furious?
Well, there's a lot of ifs there. We still got to get to WCW Saturday night, as we know. But with the Great American Bash coming up, it takes me back watching this situation right here of a young guy right here. Just as Larry said, adrenaline flowing, breaking into where the big boys play. The same could be said for Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green. Green breaking in to where the big boys play right here at WCW.
Oh, break in. You got a couple of big, dumb linemen who go into a huddle without a quarterback. They have no idea what to do. They stand around with their pads on.
I believe that Kevin Green's deal is somewhere around $7, $8 million, so the dumb part is out the window. I believe they're a little smarter than
that. He doesn't even make what I do.
Almost a three count there on Disco Inferno by Billy Kidman. Kidman is looking fantastic now. Watch this. Oh, modified bulldog right off the top rope. What an original move there by Kidman. And Kidman appears to have hurt himself there.
Yeah, original high-risk move maybe, but I think he knocked his own wind out of him.
He is just whipping the Disco Inferno from turnbuckle to turnbuckle, a belly to belly suplex.
He's got him. One, two, hit. Oh, yowza, yowza, yowza. Disco kicked out. Kidman not have enough weight to hold him down.
Oh, big kick there. And a swing. That could do it.
Made a mistake.
Disco Inferno moves over. One, two, and three.
Made a mistake, baby. Big mistake right there.
He'll learn from it.
A lot more action coming up here on WCW Pro on TBS this morning. When we come back, the franchise player, the Stinger, is in action. And more news about Nitro in a moment.
Good morning here on the Pro. You got to wake up and smell the cappuccino. I've told you for the last few weeks about the pending arrivals of talent here at World Championship Wrestling. Now, that stream of talent apparently is not even close to coming to an end. As late as last night, there were rumors flying around regarding yet another superstar coming to where the big boys play. Of course, I'm not allowed to speculate about all of this on the air, these comings and goings, but I will tell all during my exclusive hotline report all day today at 1-900-909-9900. That's 1-900-909-9900. $1.49 a minute. Kids, get your parents' permission. But for these comings and goings, you'd better call the hotline now.
Back on WCW Pro, indeed, thanks to me, Gene Okerlund, as always, you get the scoops on the hotline. And that is Hugh Morris, one of the members of the Dungeon of Doom. Apparently, he's still a member, although the Shark has been kicked out by the Taskmaster.
Well, they left him out alone, and the Giant feasted on the Shark.
Not only Shark feasted, picked him up with one arm and chokeslammed him.
I'm about to tickle someone funny bone.
Tonight on WCW Saturday Night, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson in tag team action, too.
Yeah, Flying Eyes for Blue Blood got a big thing coming in. Dallas Page, we are talking Lord of the Ring. We are talking the man that won the whole Battle Bowl situation and got, got kind of bogarted out of the world title shot. And I guarantee you, Dallas Page made a statement, like him or not, and he was there, and he beat some tough guys. But Lex Luger now is the one going after the Giant.
Lex Luger, indeed, the partner of this man, Stinger. Stinger, who had a shot at the Giant recently, and unfortunately got clocked with Jimmy Hart's megaphone that was also held by Lex Luger. A whole lot of controversy still not solved, and Sting is going to look real long and hard at Lex Luger.
Yeah, and he's going to be thanking him at the same time he's looking at him. Thanks for making me win half the championship to the world. That's what he should be saying. Too many rumors, and you guys fill them. You guys are fueling the fire.
So who's fueling the fire with this, with these football players against the wrestler? I mean, you've taken such a one-sided approach. You're blinded by the fact that these two guys are great athletes. I'm talking about Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green. We're talking Great American Bash here. Adrenaline flowing. Brother, now get this. You know how Flair sometimes gets staggered around?
Yep.
You know, we know what a tackle is in wrestling. But a sack. You ever seen a football player sack a quarterback? his whole body just eliminates him. And if Mongo McMichael, that 280 pounds, hits the Nature Boy Ric Flair with a sack, you can bet, brother, that he's going to get his lunch ate right there.
Hey, Mongo and Green, they were on teams. They were surrounded by 10 big dumb idiots like Hacksaw Duggan, who have to have a quarterback to tell them what to do because they don't have a clue. By themselves, they're nothing. Without pads, they look really small.
Who? Who you been standing next to?
Oh, me. Don't say me. Yeah.
Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green have been working out, have been training together in the gym, in the power plant, and they are ready for the Great American Bash. It is on a Sunday, Father's Day, and what a tremendous Father's Day gift that would be. What a great wrap-up to the weekend, live and only on pay-per-view, the 16th of June.
You know, I look at Sting right here, and I think back about this past Monday Nitro, him and Scott Steiner hooking it up. I mean, a legendary type match right there. You see them both now. Oh, move out of the way. And Stinger... And Lex Luger against the Steiners coming up 2 hours on TNT's Monday Nitro, WCW Monday Nitro coming up. Man, it will be something.
And it will also, in a sense, I think, gentlemen, you'd agree, be just a little bit sad. I mean, we're talking about Lex Luger and Sting and the Steiners for so long, for so many years, oh, so close. Just almost as brothers, and a real misunderstanding caused, I think, by Lex Luger.
I don't know. This is professional wrestling. This is for big money. Nobody's that close. Sting and Lex Luger, probably closer than anybody. Except for maybe a couple of brothers here and there, but I don't even know if the Steiners are that close.
I tell you something about the Steiners, though. They are here with a big boy play for one reason. Christopher Cruz, what is that? It's the world heavyweight title. Who has that? Sting and Luger. So that closeness you're talking about can go out the window, because that's what it's all about. Money, prestige, the goal at WCW to be the best, to be the best tag team there is, and the Steiners truly want that from Sting and Luger.
Still, I think we're going to see a brutal, hard-fought contest, baby. A classic this Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern, live on TNT.
It'll be a classic, because I'll be there.
All right, Sting up and over. And a power slam there by Hugh Morris.
Sting got caught. This with the arrow. Come on, ref.
Well, he took a heavy blow right there. Hey, did your boy Ric Flair, Arn Anderson, not only on Saturday night, but at Nitro, as you said, we're not going to get it to them. They will meet former World Tag Team Champions. Haven't been here for a while. I'm going to tell you, when you're going to test them.
This is a blockbuster. In fact, we're going to, during the main event, BK Wall Street taking on Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pittman. We'll have that exciting, exclusive news. You'll hear it first right here on the Pro.
Yeah, and I heard one of Sting's ribs crack, too. Hugh Morris found him wide open and just nailed him right in the rib cage.
At one time, there was certainly nobody who could match this team, this tag team, in terms of popularity here in World Championship Wrestling. And we've got them, and they're on Nitro, the hottest wrestling show each and every Monday night. The winner! Oh.
Coming out, ladies, the waist going up top now. High risk maneuver by Sting. Don't want to make a mistake on Big Hugh Morris right here. Hook him up.
High cross body block. There you go. 1, 2, and 3. And Sting of the franchise is victorious as he heads into Nitro along with Lex Luger, defending the World Tag Team Champions against the Steiner Brothers.
Boy, one blunder by Hugh Morris. He had Sting. He had him in trouble. Kicked him in the rib cage. Sting was trying to suck oxygen in. And one blunder away from victory.
Let's see this on our slow motion instant replay. It's brought to you by Sony PlayStation. Killer remotes. Smasher of egos.
All right, there. He smashed Sting's ego. But look at this. The big mistake. Sting exploded out of that corner. Got one in. Leveled him. And came off awfully quick. But here's the secret. Look at snatched that leg. And the weight was over the shoulders. Hugh Morris couldn't kick out in time.
Back in the control center and counting down to the Great American Bash. Believe it or not, we're only 2 weeks away from tomorrow night, Sunday, June the 16th at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, 4 out of the West Coast. If you can't join us in Baltimore, then make the appropriate telephone call right now and join us live on pay-per-view. As you know, WCW heavyweight champion, the Giant, to defend against the challenger, the total package, Lex Luger. This would have to be the best described, I think, as Mission Impossible. Take a look at the Giant, guys. Pay attention here. 7'4", you taking notes, 471 pounds. Is that awesome? That's awfully awesome. On another subject, football greats past and present Steve McMichael and Kevin Green are going to be meeting the Nature Boy Ric Flair and the enforcer Arn Anderson in tag team action. Boy, did this one flare up in front of a television, national television audience a couple of weeks back. Plus, just announced, U.S. champ Conan to defend against the great international star El Gato. I believe he does the plumbing here in this building, if I'm not mistaken. Is it a licensed guy? Licensed? Well, it doesn't seem like it's licensed, but that's okay. Fire and Ice, Scott Norton, and Ice Train to square off against Rick and Scott, the Steiner brothers. Plus, in the cruiserweight category, champion Dean Malenko goes up against Rey Mysterio Jr. When it comes to pay-per-view television, nobody, and I mean nobody, does it better than World Championship Wrestling. Take a look with the Giant and Lex Luger for the WCW heavyweight title. That tremendous tag team match between the football greats past and present and a couple of the greats of World Championship Wrestling. Nobody gets it any better than World Championship Wrestling. And this summertime spectacular is going to be something else. The Great American Bash, live and only on pay-per-view, 2 weeks from tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern. Make the call right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to see this main event match here, and also we're going to have news in a moment about the return of one of the most popular world tag team champs ever. That team is going to return tomorrow night, I beg your pardon, Monday night. Right. I wish it were tomorrow night on Nitro, 8 p.m. Eastern, as BK Wall Street makes his way to the ring.
Yeah, but they're going to take on Arn Anderson and Ric Flair, and again, as popular as they once was, this team, I still don't think it's going to have a chance.
But Dusty, as you know, it's a team that has defeated Arn Anderson and Ric Flair in the past.
And I tell you something here, where you talk about grudges being formed in WCW. BK Wall Street and Sergeant Craig Pittman, they've really been at each other's throats. This should be a really good matchup right here on the main event this morning on the Pro Show. You see Teddy Long, the master of motivation, if you will, with his man.
Just about 3 weeks away, as we've been saying, from the Great American Bash. Let's not forget that cruiserweight title now held by Dean Malenko to be defended by him at the Bash against Rey Mysterio Jr. A whole lot's been heard about Rey Mysterio Jr. We'll see if he lives up to his billing at the Great American Bash.
If you have not seen him in the past, you want to buy the Great American Bash on your own pay-per-view. I'm going to tell you something. This young man is electric and can thrill a crowd, brother, and knows how to put a guy away. What a matchup in the Great American Bash.
It's on Father's Day. Dad doesn't need another tie. He needs the Great American Bash. And we're back with this main event in a moment here on the Pro. Back on WCW Pro, time now for our main event. It's Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pittman against VK Wall Street. And Dusty, it's also time for that major announcement about this Monday Nitro. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson against the former tag team champions of the world.
Well, I'll tell you what, when you take a hardcore look at the history of tag team wrestling throughout WCW and the world, you take a look at guys that were giant killers. You take a look at guys in stature, were always outweighed, were always against stronger guys, were always against bigger guys, were always with their backs against the wall. But I've seen them on numerous occasions against Arn Anderson, Nature Boy Ric Flair, wrestle to an hour in the heat of the sun in Charlotte, North Carolina. Wrestle to an hour in North Carolina. We are talking the Rock and Roll Express.
Yeah.
Back at WCW, head up on Monday Night Raw, 2 hours, coming live. If you miss this one, brother, you might see the win of a lifetime from the Rock and Roll Express.
I can't see it happening, Rock and Roll Express. They know what they're doing, but Arn Anderson and Ric Flair, they've been on top of the game with the big boys play, and I just don't see it happening.
Well, these two guys match up because the length of time that Arn Anderson and your boy Ric Flair have been together, so has the Rock and Roll Express. There's nothing new here between these two teams. What's new is the Rock and Roll Express back to WCW for Monday Night Raw Live. And Pittman News right here almost got a quick win over one VK Wall Street.
As if Arn Anderson and Ric Flair didn't have enough to worry about in dealing with Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green at the Great American Bash. Now they've got to deal with the Rock and Roll Express this Monday night.
Kevin Green and Dumbo are nothing to worry about.
His name is not Dumbo.
The only thing Flair's got to worry about is where to spend Mrs. McMichael's alimony.
Yeah.
Don't you bet on it. And you know what? The same talking you're doing about Michael McMichael's wife is what Nature Boy Ric Flair was doing. And I respect you a lot, ladies and gentlemen, but be careful where you tread, brother, because the Mongo is out looking for anybody to fight right now.
He couldn't even beat up his dog.
Also on Nitro this Monday night, 8 p.m. Eastern, live from Asheville, North Carolina, Lex Luger and Sting in what has now turned into a grudge match against the Steiners for the World Tag Team Championship and the Giant defending the World Heavyweight Championship against the surprise opponent. Oh, wow, what a pickup. And he drives BK Wall Street down, goes for the cover. 1-2, almost a 3.
Yeah, kind of an awkward position here. Pittman just kind of hoisted Wall Street up and... Pittman, a strong guy, great mat wrestler, good technician. Wolfie trying to block that grip. He got it blocked, and there you go. Step out, step out.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, you know, you're right. He didn't have it really covered. He was real loose there on BK Wall Street. You see Teddy Long now rattling with him. You know, we've seen the opportunity with these two guys. When Wall Street took a victory with some outside interference, you know, always looking for that crutch, if you will. We know he's on a win streak, BK Wall Street. But right now, this thing here is more of a battle of wheels. Who wants it the most will win this thing this morning on the main event.
Well, Pittman yelling stuff that he's going to pay, but he's only going to pay if you make him, Sarge, and you better quit listening to Teddy Long. Guy's coughing them up, I think.
Whoa! Pittman goes up and over Wall Street. Oh, drop toe hold. Nice move there.
Look at the combination. I walk and follow it up with that interlocking beneath it. Boy, he just dove into oblivion there.
Gentlemen, I think you both would agree that if anybody can keep up in terms of amateur wrestling moves with Sergeant Craig the Pitbull Pittman, it's got to be a guy like VK Wall Street, who, like Pittman, has a tremendous amateur background as well.
Well, two guys, you know, I was talking along the same lines, two guys trying to co-red him right here. Didn't get him. Two guys along them same lines that know that wrestling on the blue dog. On the night of WCW Saturday night, the mothership, if you will face power of Fire Night.
Lex Luger, the world television champ, one half of the world tag team champions to face Dirty Dick Slater and Arn Anderson and Ric Flair as they face the Rock and Roll Express at Nitro to face the Armstrong tonight on WCW Saturday night. So tune in, 6.05 p.m. Eastern tonight right here on TBS.
All right there, Wall Street. He's going to get out of this situation, regroup. Wall Street's got more experience. I think Pittman, once he goes through his repertoire, is going to get a little more confused than Wall Street.
His what?
Repertoire.
Nah, his repetenda.
I knew that was coming up, and unfortunately, Wall Street didn't know the headbutt was coming. And a straight right there by Pittman.
Repetenda.
Whatever.
That's like an itinerary.
Sort of like a clubbering.
We ain't seen no clubbing in this thing because there's only one guy. Takes two guys with full.
Oh, we know. Oh, well. We know.
Maybe we'll see some clubbering tonight.
Why didn't you see that? We ought to see some clubbing tonight.
You're right there. Wall Street making his move. Now he's got Pittman reversed it. Oh, on his head. Oh, my.
Man, he put him out.
He kicked out of it.
I think that was reflexes. I think he just rolled out of it. He didn't really kick out of it. He landed right on his noggin.
Wall Street's lucky he's in the physical condition he is. He could have broke his neck easy. Pittman dumped him right on the side of his head. Well, he's still wobbly.
Pittman with another headbutt to the solar plexus. And a really weakened VK Wall Street walks out.
Pointing that finger, Long. Get out of the way.
Well, he was filibustering on him, and BK didn't take it too kindly. Oh, nailed him right there.
BK Wall Street, unfortunately for him, was distracted by Teddy Long. And he is dumped inside the ring. In comes Pittman.
Need to roll him in and beat him. Should have never put his hands on Teddy Long.
Teddy Long off of him. He's going to be disqualified.
And BK got his back turned. He's in a bad situation. Got a mistake right here.
An excite headlock off and
Nelly.
Is he gonna? Oh no! How unfair! What an injustice! He gets the 1-2-3.
Injustice! Teddy Long trying to be a Budinsky got up over in the corner, drew the referee out of position. He should have known better, seeing he's the manager of the year last year or whatever. But again, Pittman suffers the consequences. When's this guy gonna wise up and get rid of Teddy Long? Wall Street victorious.
You shut your mouth, Ron.
We'll see this again in our slow motion instant replay. Wall Street indeed victorious over Sergeant Craig, the Pitbull Pittman. Larry, let's take it.
Well, take another look. Pittman was, you know, holding his own. Wall Street, they about even in points. Right there, oh. Nice dump on the side of the head. But Long interfered, and according to Sarge Pittman now,
it's a good day for the Pros.
All right, that's going to do it for this morning's WCW Pro. I'm Cruz. For the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, the living legend, Larry Zbyszko. We'll see you next week. But watch WCW Saturday night tonight, 6:05 Eastern, and Monday Nitro this Monday night at 8. We'll see you then. Of Arn Anderson and the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Hi everyone, from the Disney MGM studios, it's WCW Pro on TBS. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbyszko, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, and Larry, Bobby Heenan may be the coach for Arn Anderson and Ric Flair, but Steve Malcolm McMichael and Kevin Green have got Randy Macho Man Savage. How do you like that?
Well, you know, I like it just fine. In fact, I'm sure Anderson, Flair, and the Brain like it. I mean, Bobby the Brain Heenan, when it comes to wrestling, in terms of that gray matter, is like Joe Montana. Now we've got Dumbo and his partner, Running Dummy. They think that they're in like Flip because they've got Macho Man. Macho Man went nuts, guys. You're being managed by a man who believes he's Napoleon Bonaparte. And the only thing that's going to happen to you, McMichaels, is Flair is going to be spending your alimony.
I got to tell you, Dusty, I think that Arn Anderson and Ric Flair have a lot to be concerned about.
Well, I tell you what, going into the Great American Bash, there is more than one opinion, if you know what I'm talking about. Let me put it real simple. The wrestling machine of Arn Anderson, Nature Boy Ric Flair, managed by one of the finest minds ever in pro wrestling, against three guys that are going to enter this thing like a bunch of crazed dogs. Who can win, the crazed dog or the wrestler? We're going to talk more about it, find out about it right here this morning on the Pro.
Also here on the Pro, Eddie Guerrero in action, the Steiner Brothers, and a main event exclusively here on WCW Pro. You won't see it anywhere else. Now, we take you to the ring here on TBS. A jam-packed WCW Pro Arena. Gentlemen, before we get too much into the program, in what apparently may become a weekly ritual, I've got to apologize to the fans. To let them know that what happened this past WCW Monday Nitro, especially at the end, was out of our control. Our sincere apologies for what happened, and we're going to show you. I know you didn't miss it this past Monday Nitro, but we're going to show you again tonight here on TBS on WCW Saturday Night, your program.
Hey, everybody's talking about the situation that transpired. Whether we're apologizing or not, judge for yourself tonight on WCW Saturday Night. I'm going to take a look at it, legend.
Well, I hope you take a close look at it, Dream, Saturday night, because I've already got my opinion on the situation.
You usually do.
Which I never apologize for anything.
Don't have to when you've been a legend.
Another tremendous two-hour program coming up this Monday night on WCW Monday Nitro. We'll be talking to you about that. But keep in mind, the Nasty Boys against the Public Enemy, just one of the great matches this Monday night. Last Monday night, so much happened, however. We heard a lot about what's happening to the Great American Bash. Both teams now, Dusty and Larry, are going to have coaches.
Well, as we said right from the start, we both have our disagreements on what's going on, me and the legend doing the Dream. Bottom line is, the Macho Man Randy Savage, state of mind, he's in legend. I'm going to tell you, sometime I got to agree with you, but the bottom line is, he's like a crazed dog, and if they go out there scatterbrained, they might get beat by Arn Anderson and Nature Boy Ric Flair.
Yeah, but see, crazed dogs do not a touchdown play make. Macho Man, he is so full of hate for Ric Flair. Is he going to be thinking rationally? No. Does he have tools to work with? No. He's got Dumbo McMichaels and Kevin the Loser Green, two guys that aren't even diamonds in the rough to polish.
What? Almost a two count there on Eddie Guerrero.
He was
on the filibuster there about them guys. I guarantee you,
he's the fine athlete. As we kick it off here on the Pro, this beautiful summer weekend.
Yeah, it's hot outside. Hot on Nitro, hot on the Pro this morning, hot on Saturday night coming up tonight. And the Great American Bash is going to be hot.
And I'm hot on the tee.
And as we said, Public Enemy against the Nasty Boys this Monday night on Nitro. We're also going to see Public Enemy in action this morning here on the Pro. And, of course, that exclusive main event. You won't see it anywhere but here on Nitro. And a bump there from Eddie Guerrero.
Well, Eddie caught the Gambler close to the ropes right there and got some good momentum. Eddie, not a big guy, but he can use his speed very well. Gambler, I think he's got a lot more aggressive here to try to slow Eddie down. Get him off his feet.
I'm just used to listening to you on Nitro. I thought maybe someday I'd be at your side.
Well, I tell you what, dream on, Cruz.
Thank you very much. Oh, man. And the Gambler trying to recover from the beating he's been taken from Eddie Guerrero.
The Gambler's right on the verge of getting a victory, and Eddie Guerrero would be a big upset city for him right here, because Eddie Guerrero, the speed, the talent, the old attitude, if you will, pound for pound, the best there is. I don't know about that, because you could say the Giant. Pound for pound, ain't nobody better than the Giant. He proved that he could choke slam anybody. And Luger, Great American Bash, only on pay-per-view. What an event that will be.
Including a man by the name of the Shark, who said, look,
he's not a fish anymore.
I'm not a fish. I'm not an avalanche. I am John Tenta. I am a man, and I will be reckoned with.
It's amazing.
He is going to face Big Bubba at the Great American Bash a week from tomorrow night.
Bubba cut his hair. Bubba cut John Tenta's
hair. Looked like he had a weed whacker.
Well, I ain't going to say nothing. Weed whacker.
It's amazing, though, John Tenta, synonymous with the same size of clothes he wears.
John Tenta and Big Bubba, of course, having a match this past Monday, Nitro. And was run out. Big Bubba was run out by the scissors, so Tenta is raring to go. He's going to face Max tonight on WCW Saturday, the Irish Whip. Look at that from Guerrero. Beautiful standing dropkick. He's cracked. He's ready to go.
Well, go, Eddie.
Now he's defying on him right here on the Pro this morning. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nothing on his head.
He sure is. We lost count. The reversal there of the whip into the turnbuckle.
I didn't lose count.
Misses.
Setting him up. High suplex. Got him up. Oh, man.
Did he land on his head?
Nice snap there by Guerrero. He's got good snap movement to all his maneuvers. And he's up on the top turnbuckle.
Froggy.
A frog splash. 1, 2, and 3. And Eddie Guerrero, great victory over the Gamblers. We kick it off hot here on WCW Pro. Quick break here on TBS. When we come back, we'll take you back to this past WCW Monday Nitro. Go away.
Yes, you brother.
You never know what's going to happen on WCW Monday Nitro. As we just saw some highlights from this past Monday night, it is chaotic, it is unpredictable, and it is the hottest program, wrestling program, every Monday night. Can you believe Heenan? Bobby Heenan is a coach?
Yeah, we've been talking about that all the time. But these guys just bring their plunder out. And I guarantee you, when they bring their plunder, there's evil doings in the mind of them guys right here. I'm talking about Public Enemy.
Well, it's hot here. I'm just carrying the table out to stay in the shade.
Hot where? To stay in the shade. The legendary legend, so you're going to use that. You're going to stand on that commentary.
Yep.
Well, as we said,
actually, it's synonymous. I know it went over your head. They're going to have this match made in the shade. See, you didn't get it.
Oh, that's right. I didn't. This is made in the shade, right?
Sonny and Rick, the Southern Posse, take it on. Rocco Rock and Johnny Grunge. Oh, look, of all ages.
It's the Public Enemy's parents.
Hey, parents, more like it.
Hey, let me tell you some guys. Bobby Heenan say, I'm going to coach. Talk about coaching Iron Anderson, Nature Boy, Ric Flair, Little Butch Woman, all in there, that whole crew. And what an up, if you will, they have. How you say when you get something up on somebody? You know what I mean? Got one up on
one
you.
Up a chip, yeah.
And they were really up on them football players until they named the man that went crazy, the Macho Man Randy Savage, to coach them. Boy, that makes up to be one electrified moment of the Great American Bash coming up.
It was a historic and really a stunning time on this past Monday Nitro when Randy Macho Man Savage, Larry, made that call from his home in Sarasota. Said, I'm going to be in the corner of Stephen Powell and Kevin Green.
Here's Savage. He's got nothing to do because he's too crazy to be let loose in public. He sits at home by the phone. All he's going to do with Dumbo and Green is confuse them. even more than they are now. All the armchair champions think that's a good move, but Macho is nuts. He's not going to help these two football goons a bit.
You see old Grungy there just running out and giving that old body block right into the corner, picking him up high, slam. Public enemy. You know, they are getting ready for the 2 hours of WCW Monday Night Show coming up live on the Nasty Boys and them. Maybe settle things once and for all.
Wow. Maybe they will.
Maybe they settle things once and for all. They've had wars. I'm talking about real wars.
You can make it, fans. I know you've been waiting for the Great American Bash. It's a week from tomorrow night, live and only on pay-per-view from the arena in Baltimore, Maryland. Sunday, June 16th, the Great American Bash, the world title on the line. Lex Luger to defend, I beg your pardon, to try to take the belt away from the Giant. And then, of course, the Monday Nitro program the following night.
You know, don't sell yourself short. Lex Luger has the ability to beat the Giant. He's had a feel for the big man. Now he knows. He says he's got the game plan. He knows how to approach the eighth wonder
watch
of the
it,
world.
Watch it, watch it, watch it. Up and wide open, Southern Cross. And that could be it. Drops the elbow, decides not to pin him, apparently. Wait a minute. And he drops the leg. Man, that's a lot of weight to come down on.
They're just laying some pain, blues, and agony down here on the Southern Hospital. You see, he got a choke on him right here. Choking on him.
You know, we talked about this before. What if Lex Luger defeats the Giant for the World Heavyweight Championship? Can you imagine what will be going through the mind of Sting? I mean, Luger would be one half of the World Tag Team Champs, would be the World Television Champion, and also the World Heavyweight Champion. Never in the history of this, the King of Sports, has that happened.
But why do you think Luger's got all those muscles to carry all the gold? You know what? Who cares what Sting thinks? If Sting was as good as Lex Luger, he'd have all those belts.
A big boot there from Rocco Rock.
Yeah. Southern Poppy had him, thought he had it going and run right into a big boot right in the middle of the face right there. And you two guys discussing things that could happen, would not happen. Only on pay-per-view, the Great American Bash, Sting don't get his shot, but I don't believe anybody can beat the Giant, because pound for pound, he's the best in the world.
And Sting's going to get a lesson served to him on a silver platter, compliments of Lord Steven Regal.
Ain't gonna happen.
Here's your world title on the line, also the Falls Count Anywhere match, the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit against the Taskmaster, a block there. And Rocco Rock and Johnny Grimes, the public enemy. And the public enemy to face the Nasty Boys this Monday night on WCW Monday Nitro. Man, it is hot.
Watch it.
World Championship Wrestling. Watch this indeed. Up, over, down. And that is going to do it for the Southern Posse. Here's one, here's two, and three.
Public enemy get a big win here this morning on the Pro.
We got a lot more tag team action coming up featuring the Steiner Brothers. Man, they have had some battles recently on Nitro with Sting and Lex Luger. That whole situation yet to be resolved. We'll take another look at this, Larry.
We're talking about
public enemy defeated the Southern Posse.
Oh, quiet. Talk about an unresolved situation coming up on Nitro. I'll be there. These guys right here, the public enemy against the Nasty Boys. Oh, I'm going to have them move me and Shivani away from ringside for that match, because that one's going to be too much to get close to. But the public enemy here, these guys are on a roll. They're determined. They have a mission in life.
And what is that?
To win the heavyweight tag team championships of the world.
Is that it? Is that for true? Is that for real?
If you were a tag team, that would be your ultimate goal.
Well,
if he was. Look at him.
I'll stop it.
Would there be a lot of wattage there, Larry? A whole lot of watts at that Nitro?
Probably. Look at right here, though. Public Enemy. Nice. Tag team unit right there. And here, talk about moves out of the blue. Hard to comprehend a strategy against the unorthodox, barbaric style of the Public Enemy.
A lot more to come. The Steiner Brothers in an exclusive main event right here on the Pro after this. Here in the control center, just about a week away from the Great American Bash, a week from this Sunday, June 16th, live from Baltimore and available only on pay-per-view. It all starts at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Call your cable company right now. How about that tremendous tag team match between the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, with Elizabeth, with Woman, and it's official, he's out of retirement.
Bobby the Brain Heenan will be in the corner of Flair and Anderson as their coach. As their coach? Vince Lombardi, he ain't. Maybe Jerry Glanville. On the other side of the fence, two NFL greats, Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green. They have convinced the Macho Man, Randy Savage, that he can aid their cause by being in their corner. One of the most talked about tag team matches in World Championship Wrestling history will be headlining the great card at the Great American Bash. Plus, WCW Heavyweight Champion, the Giant, defends against the total package, Lex Luger. He's no longer the Shark, folks. He's John Penta, and he wants revenge from Big Bubba for giving him one of the worst haircuts I have ever seen. In addition, Fire and Ice, the tag, to meet Rick and Scott, the Steiner brothers. And there must be a winner in that one. Plus, there will be more. We'll tell you about that a little bit later on in this television program. It all comes down to the Great American Bash a week from this Sunday, June 16th at 7 o'clock Eastern Time, 4 out of the West Coast. And oh, yes, a very quick note. June 16th will be Father's Day. Kids, what a great gift-giving idea for Dad for his special day. I'm sure he'll let you join him, too, to watch it. Why don't you have Mom pick up the telephone right now? Call and join us on pay-per-view for the Great American Bash. It's Father's Day. It's World Championship Wrestling action like you won't believe. I guarantee you, you won't see anything like the Bash.
Back on W Sports, socks, any more underwear, another tie. What he needs is the Great American Bash a week from tomorrow night, live and only on pay-per-view.
Call your cable system to get him right now. Pay-per-view, what is it, Larry?
Maybe he could use a new wife.
Who?
Dad.
Who? I wouldn't touch devil. Steve Armstrong getting ready to be matched up here with Dallas Page right here on the Pro this morning. And Christopher Cruz, this man went all the way back down to the outhouse, you know, and now come all the way back to the penthouse. We're talking about Diamond Dallas Page. The thing about him, though, somebody's a benefactor. Something with the glove, something with the hands. There's something about the hands that holds the key to who the benefactor is. I'm telling you, I'm studying it. I'm watching slow motion tape on it.
But can you put your finger on it? Do you know what it is yet?
Yes, almost. When I do, I'll tell you.
All right, let's hand it off to Larry now.
Well, look at Diamond Dallas Page, like Dusty said, from the gutter to the penthouse. He has a mysterious benefactor. I'm not sure who it is. But the fact of the matter is, inside that ring, there's no one in there but Diamond Dallas Page. Physical ability, getting the job done, was all in his own hands. Right there, the man with the ring.
Yeah, and you've got to give credit where credit's due. Talent-wise, he really turned it up a notch. Doing that big old stogie, that might be one of them Arturo Fuentes 858s that I gave him. Anyway, bottom line, on the other situation here, can you imagine Steve McMichael and Kevin Green now, how good they actually going to be now that they got guidance from the coaching of the Macho Man Randy Savage? Are they going to be crazed dogs or not when they run right through the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Iron Anderson?
Yeah, they're going to be crazed dogs when Flair and Anderson are spending Green and McMichael's alimony check.
Can I say
something? That's the only thing Macho Man can guide them into.
Can I say something? Okay, first of all, great job with my co-host, Tony Schiavone, your co-host now at Nitro, Tony Schiavone, okay? I know you're hosting that thing. You did a great job. But did not the Rock and Roll Express take Iron and the Nature Boy Ric Flair to the limit? Did they not take it to them?
The Rock and Roll Express have been wrestling for 20 years. Dumbo McMichael and running dummy Kevin Green never wrestled a day in their life. They're dog meat. You know what? Bobby Heenan, instead of McMichael's holding poo-poo in his arm,
ooh,
Bobby Heenan's going to be holding what's left of Kevin Green in his hand as he does the commentary.
I got to give you this. The Brain is the man. But I just think they're going to be ready for this thing. And Dallas Page now shaking hands with Armstrong. Armstrong fell for it and now got kicked in the belly welly and elbows behind the head, Christopher Cruz. And this thing, while me and Larry were transpiring, already got underway.
Well, I think you're right. He did sucker Steve Armstrong, but Armstrong is recovering, and Dallas Page immediately goes for the ropes.
See, smart man, Diamond Dallas, let the ring break the hold for you. Let the referee get in there. Make him work. Don't expel energy if you don't have to. You know, maybe Diamond Dallas, the benefactor, is sitting right out there in the audience, and no one knows who it is. He could be looking over for something, and no one would know.
How about this one? He might be sitting at our table right here.
That was
right
bad.
Here in the arena.
See? Could be out there.
should be at your unit right here at our table, at our booth.
That's a scary thought.
You never know who the benefactor is.
It's either an accusation, an intimation, or something else. That's a hammerlock there from Diamond Ellis Page. A reversal there, and Page trying to sit his way out of it. Steve Armstrong, very well versed in wrestling, dropped toe hold, and so is Page.
Well, that just shows you how much Page, how long he's come a long way, and being able to get in and out of holds. But right there, Armstrong is too quick and too fast for him. Maneuvered himself over to the rope, pulled outside, get a breath or two, waiting to get back in there.
Still on the roll.
I'm talking about a man that upset the world when he won the ring, brother.
Well, he shocked the world. The Diamond Dallas always, I mean, how do you think he made it in the streets? He gave all the homeless people the diamond cutter and then got their, you know, quarters or whatever they begged throughout the day and lived off of that.
Sometimes you talk about me, you do. You say things about me that derogatory. But, man, sometimes you can come up with such a line that it's almost impossible for me to figure out what you're talking about.
Well, that's what would make sense to me. Let the beggars go out, beg for the quarters. They come back. You give them the diamond cutter, take their quarters. Who's going to care about homeless bodies laying around the street?
Well, he's looking good right here this morning on the Pro. Getting ready for WCW Nitro. 2 hours coming up Saturday night. Coming up tonight, lost Steven Regal. That young man, Billy Kidman. We're talking about Hugh Morris and Stinger. What a show tonight. But it just keeps getting better and better and hotter and hotter. And it goes right into Monday Live on TNT, WCW Monday Nitro. 2 hours long.
In fact, tonight the Steiners are going to be facing fire and ice. The Steiners in action right here this morning on the Pro, and also our main event. Look at that leapfrog there.
Oh, yes.
Takeover, and DDP goes up and over. The main event this morning right here on the Pro, dropkick. Something different, something special, something you used to see all the time in professional wrestling, and we're bringing it back in our main event this morning right here on the Pro. Oh, man, what was that?
I think he knocked a tooth out. Well, the benefactor can buy him a new one.
Oh.
Oh, he got him anyway.
You see how he ducked under that? Larry just got rid of him and tossed him aside. Like, that's just like Steve McMichael getting Ric Flair up in his bear hug and just tossing him across there like that.
Yeah, well, when McMichael breaks out of the figure four and starts crying like a baby, let me know.
There's no great athletes in the world professional wrestling, period.
Absolutely.
What I'm seeing right now with the guidance of the Macho Man Randy Savage, there might be enough there for these two great athletes. I'm talking about Mike Michaels and Green to put it on the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Arn Anderson.
The only advice.
Man, he just licked it.
Look at Diamond. I mean, tall guy, 6'5", strong guy, picked up Armstrong, dumped him right in the trunk. I think he banged his chin back, too.
And again, he raises those hands, almost symbolic. 1, 2, and 3.
Oh, come on, ref.
No.
Diamond knows that was a slow count.
Very close to a 3, and DDP, will he try another gut wrench and get up into the backbreaker? That's a lot of strength going for him there, Steve. No.
Got it.
Tries to hang on for the backslide.
Got to
get him over. Yes.
Got to get him over. Got him.
He's got 1, 2, and was that a 3? No, apparently a 2. So many close counts here. Short clothesline. Hook of the leg. This could be it. One. Again, just a 3 count.
Boy, that ref is... 3 count.
A 2 count, I beg your pardon.
Well, you know,
he's slow and you're quick.
Thank you. Well, as we said, this Monday night, 2 action-packed hours. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson in individual action on our sister network, TNT. The Nasty Boys take on the Public Enemy, and the Giant defends the World Heavyweight Championship as he heads into the Great American Bash a week from tomorrow night for possibly the biggest match of his career. It's against Lex Luger.
Tell him, Diamond.
As we said, still to come in action this morning here on the Pro, the Steiner Brothers, and that exclusive, special, different main event. We'll have it here only on the Pro. Attempt to power out there by Steve Armstrong, pulling the hair by DDP, and a beautiful suplex. That'll break the hold.
Yeah, well, he stayed in that headlock too long in the upright position. Armstrong finally got the leverage up to pick up 6'5", a Diamond Dallas Page. But Kenny, you know, Diamond Dallas beat him up. Armstrong couldn't get to him in time.
Yeah, Dallas beat him up, beat him to the punch. And now they're going to try to put him away.
Oh! Well, speaking of football.
Yeah, speaking of football, can you imagine that?
Through the uprights. And look at this. Whatever DDP has got, Steve Armstrong is able to counter it. Now the whip and a beautiful flying elbow.
Got him right in the sternum, but he's wasting time.
No, he's going up top
yeah,
right
here. Yeah, but it's too long. Diamond's already getting up.
High risk maneuver coming from the top right here. Steve Armstrong, perch high above. He caught him right there. Hooked the leg.
He sure did. This could be it. One, two, and...
Was that a three? What happened?
It was a two count. That's what happened.
Well, I'll tell you what, that referee was a little bit slow on that number three right there. I guarantee you.
And again, the whip and DDP with his own elbow out of the turnbuckle. Hey, wait a minute. He's got his feet on the ropes. All right. Apparently, Steve Armstrong able to kick out of there. What is that? The referee got to get into a fight with DDP.
Steve, but Diamond's smart. He's not giving him any time to regroup. He's right back on top of Armstrong here. He's going up. No, he blocked it.
He blocked it again. The roll up. One, two, and... almost a three there. Man, oh, man.
Boy, he was right on him right there. Pick him up, Diamond Cutter.
Yeah, turn out the leg. The party's over.
There's the three count on Steve Armstrong. Good fight, but DDP with the Diamond Cutter.
Got him, baby.
See, nice move. Diamond saw it coming. Doc hooked on that Diamond Cutter. Again, probably wiped out two or three homeless people, but he's got that move down to a science now.
He's got the hand job going, too. Doing that hand job on TV. You see it right there, Dallas Page. Moving on down the line.
The family outing. Mom, Dad, the kids, and meat on the grill.
This ain't no picnic.
It's WCW's Great American Bash. Forget the Backyard Olympics. We've got our own. It's a WCW Father's Day you'll never forget. The Great American Bash. Live and only on pay-per-view. Satellite dish owners, call 1-800-843-9266.
Good morning. Attention hotline fans. What or who could have persuaded Bobby the Brain Heenan to return to Matty Jean here in World Championship Wrestling? It's rumored that big money was put up by a certain individual who's about to arrive here at WCW. Plus, allegedly, another major, major superstar has given his notice and not at WCW. What's in his future? Could he be coming to where the big boys play? I'm going to have those and other stories during my exclusive hotline report, right on up until midnight today on the WCW hotline. And I do mean they are hot. Call 1-900-909-9900. That's 1-900-909-9900.
Call right now. Well, thank you, Mean Gene. It's always good to get the report from the hotline. Call each and every day for the latest World Championship Wrestling. And now, on come the team that has had some tremendous battles on Nitro the past couple of weeks with Lex Luger and Sting. No longer good friends. They seem to be bitter enemies. The Steiners.
Well, I don't know. At the end of that situation the other night, the Steiner, you know, Scott Steiner was standing there with Sting and Luger and Rick, the dog, was out there on the floor being chokeslammed by the Giant. Giant being chokeslamming everybody. So when you take a hard, cold look at it, I think in the heat of battle, going for the title, things happen. And I know that these two guys right here, like the legendary Larry Zbyszko said about public enemy, if you will, is that they want the World Tag Team title, no matter who's got it.
See, everybody wants it, and the word friendship only exists in the hearts and minds of little kids that are growing up next door to each other so they can borrow one another's toys and break them. In professional wrestling, for big money, friendship is not a word that exists in the wrestler's dictionary. This is for big money. This is where the big boys play to win, and nobody is anybody's friend.
A lot of power there with Scott Steiner. You see that, Christopher Cruz?
Indeed, I did. And Dusty, I think now it may be time to talk about the main event this morning here on the Pro.
Well, when you talk about unusual situation, we're talking about Nitro coming up, talking about the Great American Bash on pay-per-view from Baltimore, and we're seeing the nervy hole king right here, Pat Tanaka, taking a look at the Steiners right there, seeing all that, and just got rid of it. We got to think about a great athlete. She came here, she already gave away. But Medusa came here, the number one. Colonel Parker stole Colonel Parker, if you will, and the bottom line, then went out and whipped Colonel Parker's Hina, if you will. Bottom line, Medusa will face one of her arch rivals right here this morning in Bull Nakata
from Japan.
A match you will see only here on WCW.
Not tonight, not on Nitro, right here.
Next. Chris Nelson in there now against the dog-faced Gremlin. Collar and elbow tie up, and Nelson pushes Rick Steiner back up. Oh, and goes for some shots to the gut, to the head, and just one from Rick Steiner levels his opponent.
Yep. Who is his opponent?
That's Chris Nelson.
Whoa. I bet you all I've been had to turn over McRae seeing this kid out there.
And Nelson kicks out. That's a surprise.
Nelson. Ricky,
well, get here.
Rick
Scotty Nelson. Steiner. Oh, no.
Gotta get that. That one right on your head, man.
Uh-oh. Belly to belly here. Scotty, nice snap to this one.
That's right over your head.
Wow. Here come the baddest dog in the pound now. Rick Steiner coming in here. A man had been choke slammed by the Giant. And his brother, I'm talking about Scott. Whoa. No, baby.
Oh. Man plants him on his head.
Showtime
indeed. Hooks the leg, didn't need to do that, but got the 1-2-3. Steiner's victorious.
Good call, Larry.
Thank you. No problem at all ahead for Rick and Scott Steiner. You know, Steiner brothers are good wrestlers. Emotionally a little unstable. Scotty probably more so. The dog-faced Gremlin here, he's just borderline. He's close to Macho Man.
They face Fire and Ice tonight on WCW Saturday night. We'll see that again in our slow motion as pre-play. Brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT. Call 1-800-COLLECT from any phone to any phone. Boom! Save!
All right, here's Steiner's. They saved a lot of TV time. Didn't take them too long to crash, bang, Mr. Nelson here. Good tag team effort here up on the shoulders of Rick Steiner. Super DDT by Scott. Man, he just nailed this kid.
They're going to carry Chris Nelson out, and we're going to take a very quick break. And when we come back, it's our main event. Bull Nakano takes on Medusa right here exclusively on The Pro. We're back in a moment. Welcome back to WCW Pro. It's the match we've been waiting for all hour. This exclusive presentation of this main event. Medusa taking on Bull Nakano. And we're going to have to try to keep up with all the action these two can put out. Man. And here she comes. Medusa back in World Championship Wrestling. Look at
well, she hasn't been anywhere right here with the big boys and big girls place. She had an opportunity, though, to put it on Colonel Parker. We've seen that round robin thing go ahead, and she was not scared of backing down. But I'm going to tell you what, I know something on Bull Nakano in Japan. She is an awesome superstar over there. She is an awesome power over there. You're going to see how big, and when you talk about Coyote, Ugly, you know, not to say anything, but you're getting ready to take a look at it right here.
Coyote Ugly.
Oh, man.
All right, and now we're awaiting the entrance of this Japanese superstar. We've seen her before here in World Championship Wrestling, and look at that gorgeous outfit.
I wouldn't be caught dead in that thing.
Yeah. And I tell you what, maybe it's the way she's painted when I'm talking about Coyote or something, but her hair is about 15 foot tall. You see that? And it goes into a peak like Mount Rushmore.
All
right. Going to be something.
We'll have this main event for you.
Hi again, everybody. We're back at the Control Center and just a week away from the Great American Bash next Sunday, June 16th, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. And, of course, it's only available on pay-per-view. Oh, my. Bobby the Brain Heenan now will manage Ric Flair and Arn Anderson as they tag to meet the NFL past and present. Steve Bongo McMichael and Kevin Green with the acrimonious Macho Man Randy Savage in their corner. Savage, of course, has been suspended as a wrestler. He makes Albert Bell and Claude Lemieux look like a couple of Sunday school kids. But Savage will be allowed to manage Green and McMichael. This should be one of the greatest tag matches in professional wrestling history. Hey, the biggest WCW heavyweight champion of all time, the 7'4", 474-pound giant, will be defending against challenger of the total package, Lex Luger. Jimmy Hart will be in the Giant's corner. In other action, Cruiserweight champion Dean Malenko to meet Rey Mysterio Jr. Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan squares off with Chris Benoit and Falls Count Anywhere. U.S. champ Conan to defend against El Gato. Plus Diamond Dallas Page locks up with Marcus Alexander Bagwell. And what about that slap to the face of Sting by Lord Steven Regal? Those two men to meet at the Great American Bash. World Championship Wrestling, the preeminent pay-per-view sports entertainment supplier. Call right now to guarantee that if you can't join us in Baltimore, that you can join us on pay-per-view a week from this Sunday night. Call your cable company, satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266 or DirecTV 1-800-347-3288. Whatever you do this Father's Day, don't miss the Great American Bash a week from this Sunday, June the 16th.
On WCW Pro on TBS, Bull Nakano against Medusa.
Whoa!
Oh, that hurt right on the belly. Well, it spun around there. I guarantee you.
Bull Nakano with the viciousness.
We've seen it right here this morning on the Pro exclusively. Sports fans, don't turn your sets off.
Man, that is not, she has leveled Medusa.
That is not a haze. That is not a, you got something to say, Larry.
You go ahead. I'm sorry. I broke in.
We always break in. Yeah. Right here. Bull might break Medusa's neck using the ropes for leverage right there. I can finally see.
As great as
okay, good.
The
good.
Action has been here on WCW Pro. Still to come, WCW Saturday night. We're going to see the Steiners take on Fire and Ice. The new John Tenta. He ain't a shark.
No.
He ain't a fish. He ain't an avalanche.
Speaking of Hugh Moss and more news tonight on WCW Saturday night concerning that big lap 2-hour WCW TNT Monday Nitro coming up this Monday. It's going to be on fire. The giant nasty ball pelican, man. So much going on. But the Great American Bash, once again, the newly found coaching of the macho man Randy Savage will send these two great athletes out there like crazy dogs and run through the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. Coach me, I might add, coached by one of the greatest of all time, whether I like him or not.
It is a week from tomorrow night, live and only on pay-per-view. Have you made the call to your cable company? If not, why not? It's time to do that as Medusa grabs that, the big hair, I guess, the ultimate in big hair, and a chop there on Bull Nakano.
Well, it's sticking. Bam! What a clothesline! Bull just exploded! In the face of the Medusa.
I see the legend. I and a half, that Bull Nakano. I guarantee you.
Ironing?
No, iron. Like iron. Putting an iron. Oh, look. She got veins running all over her face. I'm talking about bad. I guarantee you, what I said about her coming from Japan, she is legendary over there. And she is a champion status. And right now, coming here to destroy our Medusa right here on the Pro this morning.
What do you mean our Medusa? That was
WCW Medusa.
Well, it was Colonel Parker's. She wrecked a man's life.
Well,
housebreaker.
She's in dire straits right now. Oh, look at this. A little form of the Scorpion Deathlock. The kind of bulldog right here trying to get over.
She's got enough weight that she can turn the Medusa. What a
look at this.
She's got in a reverse surfboard.
Very good. A reverse surfboard with a leg lock.
You can see the pain etched in the face of Medusa. I can't believe that she has not given up already. You know, just getting word on what is coming up next week here on WCW Pro as the Japanese invasion continues. It's Masachoto and Kensuke Sasaki against the Steiner brothers. Wait a minute, Nakano just sits on Medusa. 1-2. And Medusa rolls out. Also, Jushin Thunder Liger takes on Eddie Guerrero. We'll see Ric Flair in action. All that and
turn
much more
trying
next
to turn
week
over.
Here on the Pro.
Well,
she's stretching her out.
Let me make a wish. I hope I hit the lotto.
Oh, man. I'm going to tell you what. She has dominated this situation with Medusa right here. She's some great moves. Great power moves.
A great
stretching move.
Yeah, great painful moves, too, in this position. It's smart.
And now biting her on the finger. How would you like to show up now and put yourself, we always talk about the girl showing up with the guys that see their mom and dad. How you like to go home, see your mom and dad, and introduce Bull Nakano as your date for the night? I guarantee you, my dad would have beat me to death trying to go out with her. He'd have jumped on me.
Before she jumped on you.
Well, she what?
Not big enough to be a dream ass.
Yes, she is.
All right, she is.
And finally, Medusa showing some fire, some offense, unanswered kicks.
Go ahead, girl. Go ahead, girl. Jump back, girl.
Now the whip on Nakano. Spinning kick. Medusa goes for the pin. One. Almost a Well, 2.5 it looked like there.
Yeah, the bull's big. Couldn't cradle her up enough to get the weight over. And right back on the hair of Medusa, and up she goes.
Snoop slam and down. Man, these women are just brutalizing one another. 1-2, and did you see that?
Nipped up right out of it, come right out of it. Got about a head ahead. Got a once, going for it again. Go on, girl. Yes.
Medusa is on a roll after taking a severe beating at the hands of Bull Nakano throughout most of this match. And again, the cover. No.
He kind of grabbed her by the hair and snapped her down backwards. The bull's getting up slow.
Oh, unbelievable.
Saw the Medusa come inside, stepped her.
Watch this, guys. Watch this. Everybody take a look at this thing. It's Scourge right here this morning on the Pro. Got a hooked up leg lock. Talked her right over. I like that. The bull that kind of didn't get to go ahead and splash her. I wonder would it be a froggy splash like Guerrero used, or would it have been a bull splash?
Man, a bullfrog.
Oh, that's more. Hey, wait a minute. 1, 2, and 3.
Yes. He got her.
Yes.
Medusa defeating Bull Nakano.
Good one.
What a hard-fought match this has been. Good one indeed. Good.
Yes. Very nice. Very nice.
As we said, still to come. I beg your pardon. Not still to come. Unfortunately, we don't have too much more time. But next week, Jushin Thunder Liger takes on Eddie Guerrero. Masachono and Kensuke Sasaki against the Steiners. We'll see Ric Flair in a whole lot more. But now, let's take another look at how Medusa defeated Bull Nakano.
Right there, I think Bull was ahead on points. Look at her whip Medusa around by that hair. Right here, Medusa made a move, snapping back on the neck of the bull, snapped her head down, and I think it was the old Razzle Dazzle in the corner. Right there, look at the nice snap bridge. Nice bridge by Medusa.
For the living legend, Larry Zbyszko, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Fans, we'll see you next week on the Pro. We'll see you tonight on WCW Saturday night and this Monday night on WCW Monday Nitro. We'll see you. It's the Great American Bash, live and only on pay-per-view tomorrow night. Fans, have you made that all-important call to your cable company? Hi, everyone. I'm Cruz, along with the living legend Larry Zbyszko, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, here on WCW Pro on TBS this morning. And Larry, tomorrow night, it's the WCW against the NFL, and Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green are ready.
Oh, you gotta be kidding. How appalled I was being there live on Nitro, watching Steve Dumbo McMichael's wife coming out, begging for mercy, pleading, going right up to Ric Flair and Bobby Heenan, trying to cancel the match. McMichael's is hiding behind a woman's skirt. He's a coward. He's a chicken. You know, him and his partner, Running Dummy Green, probably had a conversation with Macho Man, realized he's completely nuts, and now they're all running for the hill.
I gotta tell you, Dusty, I think you'll have a lot different take on that.
Well, let me tell you something, Evelyn Wood. I read this thing a little bit different. I guarantee you it was just self-love for a husband. A woman's love trying to get in this thing. This pay-per-view is so big, you better get it. Let's go to the ring right now.
The distinctive music of Jushin Thunder Liger.
Distinctive? Sounds like some guy had too much sake trying to play a harp.
Well, I'll tell you what, guys, going back to what we talked about at the get-go right here, the Great American Bash only on pay-per-view tomorrow, and what a weekend we got here. But let me set something straight on here to where the legend was talking about, the woman going out there and the Mongo McMichael hiding behind the skirt. Bottom line, my friend, is Mongo McMichael is an athlete of the 90s, and I guarantee you, he will take this thing personal. And when you play personal vendettas nowadays in this great sport, you find out a very violent thing could happen to the Great American Bash.
Personal vendetta. Dumbo shot off his big mouth. Now he wanted to chicken out. He sent his wife into bed for mercy.
That is not
and
true.
Who's his partner?
Kevin Green.
But even Jay Leno called him shallow grave. Arn Anderson and Ric Flair, they've already got two of them dug. For Dumbo and Running Dummy.
Well, Chris Cruz, the bottom line on this situation is the great athletes of WCW, the Nature Boy Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, against two great athletes, period. Bottom line, can a football player beat a wrestler? Only on pay-per-view will you find out. But what all I'm saying is it's become more explosive with the situation with Deborah McMichael and what went on at this past Monday Nitro, and I believe that Mongo McMichael is going to be an insane individual, even more so than the Macho Man Randy Savage. Speaking of the Macho, I know you got news on that situation.
Indeed we do, and obviously Deborah McMichael said, look, I can't be responsible. My husband is going to hurt somebody. Please, let's find a way to call this off.
Papa, he's going to hurt himself.
And indeed, as we know, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson will be coached by Bobby the Brain Heenan, Randy Macho Man Savage to be in the corner of Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green. The suspension of the Macho Man Randy Savage is over as of the 17th of June.
All right.
We have a special announcement about the effects of the end of that suspension.
Yeah.
A little bit later in the Pro.
Right here on the Pro this right. Morning, right here on TBS. What a matchup we got going here. Legendary Larry Zbyszko. Looking at two tremendous athletes, Jushin Thunder Liger and Eddie Guerrero. Watch out, high risk.
Oh, nice move by Eddie. Good leapfrog. Oh, man, what a move. Liger pulled out. Somersaulting down, coming up at the back of the heel, right smack in the face of Eddie Guerrero.
And Guerrero and Liger have met before, and there has been never really been any conclusive conclusion to the contest between the two, and wow, we can see why.
This is definitely a flip of the coin matchup right here. Both these guys probably about the same weight, very quick on their feet, good on the mat, good in the air, and Liger got him again.
I'll tell you, when you talk about the same weight, you take a look at the World's Heavyweight title match coming up on pay-per-view at the Great American Bash in Baltimore tomorrow night. The Giant defending that title against Lex Luger. Strength-wise, many questions have been asked. Can Luger wreck the Giant? And you're only going to find out if you buy this pay-per-view.
Also, there must be a winner in that match between Fire and Ice and the Steiner Brothers. Oh, man, and we'll see the Steiner Brothers a little bit later in the show this morning here on TBS.
I think Liger's seeing stars, came back a little bit too far. Oh, two-count nailed himself on the back of the head. He's upset with himself. He knows he made a little mistake there, but...
Yeah, I got to agree with you in that situation. I thought he had to win right
there. That's a face only a dreamette could love.
What do you mean, Judd? No, I'm not going to dreamette right here. A lot of dreamettes going to be down in Baltimore tomorrow night at the pay-per-view.
Also tomorrow night, the Cruiserweight title on the line. Dean Malenko, the current champion, defending against Rey Mysterio Jr. As we look at Guerrero, a chop there by Jushin Thunder Liger. Both these individuals made it far in the Cruiserweight tournament here in World Championship Wrestling. Great clothesline by Guerrero. He is fired up.
Fire, but he better move.
Rey Mysterio Jr., possibly the most highly rated Mexican superstar ever in the history of that great sport in that great country. And we can't wait to see the masked Rey Mysterio Jr. A lot of folks think he will come in his first match here in WCW and take away that Cruiserweight title from the man of a thousand holds, Dean Malenko.
Liger about took away the small of the back of Eddie Guerrero. And right there, just dumped him down again. It should be it. Oh, come on.
Guerrero just barely able to kick out, and Liger saying that was a three count. That was a three count.
I think in Japan, they're a little quicker on the count.
Well, he's had his way with Eddie Guerrero, but we have seen in numerous occasions, if you don't put Eddie Guerrero away, know when to put him away, get him quick, then he can come back to haunt you right up top right here. Looks like he's going to go up and try one of them high-risk maneuvers.
Oh, no. Superplex. Are you kidding me? Guerrero said, no way.
Hey. That's the frog splash. Put it nowhere. The Jack Dyson and Guerrero has defeated Jushin Thunder Liger this morning right here on the Pro. Man, oh, man.
Boy, what a turn of events. I always say it. 3 seconds away from being over a wrestling match, but Guerrero proved me right again. And Liger was looking good. He was ahead on points. Going up to that turnbuckle, I think. Eddie Guerrero shoved him off the top, just knocked the wind out of him, and Frog splashed him out of the blue.
We'll take a look at our Pep Boys Power Pit of the Week. It's brought to you by Pep Boys, America's auto parts superstore.
All right there, super moves by Liger, and watch this. Look at the momentum, dumped him right on the tip of the small of the back, but right here, Liger made his mistake, got shoved off, knocked the wind, and this time, Eddie followed it up quickly.
News about Saturday night, about the Great American Bash, and a whole lot more of the Steiner Brothers next on the Pro. This past Monday night on WCW's Monday Nitro on TNT, two big individuals came down to World Championship Wrestling to make a challenge. You know who they are,
And so do we. And Dusty, I think a lot of folks were very upset about that. Larry, I know you were upset as well. A lot of history here in World Championship Wrestling. Essentially, a war was declared. Well, tomorrow night, live on pay-per-view at the Great American Bash, we are going to find out if indeed that challenge will be accepted by World Championship Wrestling, and if the challenge is accepted, how the match will take place, where, and when. And Dusty, a whole lot of history here in World Championship Wrestling. You made a lot of it. I don't think you appreciate a challenge like that at all.
No, I like a good fight. I like a good wall. These two guys right now are doing nothing but lip service, if you know what I'm talking about. Where the big boys play, there is no better, no bigger, nowhere. So they got to understand that's about 50 guys will accept that challenge.
Those two big guys, Larry, came at World Championship Wrestling with a big challenge, and I know that you are loyal to the organization as well.
Well, you know, one of the problems with people in the world is they want this, they want that, and then when they get it, they realize they really didn't want it in the first place.
All right, as we said, we're going to find out tomorrow night live at the Great American Bash if the challenge is accepted. We take you now back to WCW's Monday Nitro. Action here on WCW Pro. About to see two of the compatriots of Jushin Thunder Liger, Kensuke Sasaki, the former U.S. heavyweight champ, along with Masa Chono, to face the Steiner brothers. And the Steiner brothers have got one heck of a weekend, starting with these two this morning.
And they got Hall of Heat tonight on WCW Saturday Night, the mothership home, back Great American Back Talk tonight, and Saturday night, more today, much less going into Nitro, but the Great American Back right around the corner.
Great American Bash fans, make sure you call your cable company and be a part of the excitement of the Bash. We're going to find out tomorrow night just when, where, how, and if WCW will accept the challenge from those two invaders. Look, I guess it's us against them. It's a war. They say we wanted a war. They're going to bring us a war. We'll deal with that. But the apologizing is over.
You know, people who suffer from delusions of grandeur wind up to be just people suffering.
You know, I agree so much with the legend on this situation right now. This has become a real personal issue to anybody that's ever put on a pair of tights at WCW. Anybody that's ever walked that aisle down there, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, the Dusty Rhodes, the legendary Larry Zbyszko, the Lex Luger, the Giant, and two guys coming in here, lip servicing, saying, hey, roughing up one Eric Bischoff on this pipe past Nitro and trying to lay down a law of what they want to do. And a third guy somewhere, we don't know who it is, but I guarantee you tomorrow night, you know, main event, I'm going to be there with Eric Bischoff. Bottom line, at the pay-per-view, on pay-per-view, brother, I believe they're going to get told where, when, how, and what's going to happen.
You know, it doesn't take much guts to push around a little puny guy.
Masahiro Chono and Kensuke Sasaki go on the attack against the Steiner brothers. As we said, the Steiners to meet the Heart of Heat tonight on WCW Saturday night at the Great American Bash. They meet fire and ice in a match in which there must be a winner. And we'll tell you in a moment, the Steiners in individual action on this Monday Nitro. You're not going to believe that.
Well, Chris, you know, anytime the Steiners step in there, they want to finish. They want to win. They want to end it to the situation, just like with these two guys. But Son of Ono, come on over here. Bring these two guys to the ring, knowing one thing, pride from the great country of Japan. Two great athletes got to face the Steiners. They faced them before over there. I've seen Tokyo Dome been sold out. Whoa. With this situation. So this is a big matchup this morning on the Pro.
Scotty Steiner with Kensuke Sasaki and a belly-to-belly, just like Rick Steiner got Masahiro Chono.
Well, you know, the Steiners have reversed the situation. Now you've got the Japanese boys outside on the floor. And, of course, talk about being outside on the floor, Benoit versus the Taskmaster. You know, as good as Benoit is, as much as I like him, as much as an athlete he is, he better realize when he gets in the ring with the Taskmaster, he's dealing with a different kind of human being. And he better be ready for it.
Yeah, if it was just a match inside the ring, Chris Benoit might have an upper hand. This is fought anywhere in the building, anywhere in the country, anywhere, wherever it's at pay-per-view. And once you get outside the Taskmaster, I don't believe this thing will even get in the ring. I believe the Taskmaster has the cards in his hand to deal the right hand right here, because he knows he got to destroy him. He needs allies. You know why? Because Hulkamania is not dead, and the Taskmaster is bent on selling that score.
Well, the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit, his fellow horseman Arn Anderson, says at the Great American Bash, the truth will be known. The truth will come out. What does that mean? Well, we're going to find out live and on pay-per-view tomorrow night. I can't get over the gall of those two big guys coming down, breaking up the WCW Monday Nitro show. We've got to apologize for a couple of weeks, and they've got the gall to challenge an organization that's been around since 1905. Who the you-know-what do they think they are? Exactly. We're going to find out just if WCW accept the challenge tomorrow night at the Great American Bash. You think we're going to back down? That ain't going to happen. Rick Steiner now, excuse me, I beg your pardon for getting off of that, but Rick Steiner nailing Kazuki Sasaki, the former U.S. heavyweight champion. What goal? I just can't believe.
All right, now Steiner's not that focused. He's not paying attention to his ring positioning. Backed right into Chono, and, well, that's the wrong place to go.
A suplex, and he drops him right on the back of his neck. And goes for the lateral press, gets one, two, almost a three on Rick Steiner.
The television ring appearances of the Macho Man Randy Savage has been lifted, as you said, as of the 17th. But he holds a key to this pay-per-view, the Great American Bash, with McMichaels and Kevin Green. Can he handle a situation to drive them guys against two of the greatest wrestlers that ever put on the pad tight? And with the coaching of Bobby the Brain Heenan, it's going to be tough.
The only place Macho Man's going to drive Dumbo and running dummy Green is to the cuckoo's nest. He thinks he's Napoleon. He's going to be running around the ring looking for Josephine.
He may be running around the ring looking for the Nature Boy, yeah, Ric Flair.
Probably picking up all the money that Miss Elizabeth thrown to the fans, to the kids.
As of Monday, this Monday Nitro, Macho Man Randy Savage's suspension has been lifted. He now can wrestle on television. Who does he want? Obviously, he wants the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. At Nitro, Rick Steiner, who's in the ring now, is going to face Stevie Ray of Harlem Heat.
Oh, hey, Steiner!
And Rick Steiner, man, he's sure dead, a belly-to-belly off the top rope. He's crawling. He reaches Scotty. In comes Scott Steiner.
He got him up.
Well, he's Steiner is pumped, man. Yeah. Look at that. Oh!
Whoa.
Hey! Low blow. Low blow.
That stopped that right there.
Here comes the high shot. Oh, he ducked it.
Make him the Macho Man. Obviously, we know he's going to be at the Great American Bash. Oh. In the corner of Steve McMichael and Kevin Green as a coach. They think they need one. They couldn't get anyone better than Macho Man.
There is one better. His name is Bobby Heenan.
Oh, the Frankensteiner. And Scotty, one, two, and three. Yes, Heenan indeed will be the coach at the Great American Bash live on paper tomorrow night.
Who would you rather have in your corner coach against? A guy like Heenan who can relate like Joe Montana or Macho Man who thinks he's Napoleon Bonaparte. Come on, guys.
Get the phone now. Make the phone call to your cable company. Make sure you're a part of the Great American Bash. Man, oh, man. What a pay-per-view it is going to be tomorrow night.
The Steiner brothers are ready for Saturday night. Hall of Heat coming up tonight on TBS.
And a lot more about the Steiners and the Bash right after this. Don't go away. Bash Control Center, there is still time to make that call to your cable company and be a part of the excitement of the Great American Bash. Hey, what if the Giant is defeated by Lex Luger for the World Heavyweight Championship? Monday night, this Monday night, the Giant is to face Scott Steiner in a grudge match, and Scott Steiner believes that that match will be for the World Heavyweight Championship. Who knows? Lex Luger may have the title on Monday night.
Speaking of people who may be left out, now who's this coach from Carolina, Don Caper?
Don Caper.
You can imagine Don Caper falling off his couch, holding his chest when he sees Kevin Green in the figure four running gunny, who will never be able to run for anybody again.
Well, Dusty, you know, I was also going to say, Disco Inferno takes on Joe Gomez. Joe Gomez, his Nitro, this will be his debut, of course. Well, we know he, along with the Renegade, was supposed to debut last
year. He had a debut coming up. And that debut, going back to what Larry said, the legendary Larry Zbysko saying about the pitiful leg locks put on him back there in the auxiliary room, if you will. You know what I'm talking about. Once Deborah had been almost
begging,
booted out. Well, not begging, but don't give me that. Bottom line is, we're going to see him
at Nitro. But the Great American Bash, the question is, can Luger wreck the Giant? And I believe for him to beat the Giant, he has to put him up in the wreck.
Well, can you imagine?
I don't know, Lex Luger, genetic wonder that, you know, that he is, but still, you know, he's not adverse to kryptonite. Put the Giant in the wreck. Definitely is a superhuman feat.
And in a falls count anywhere match, in the concession stands, on the tables, obviously anywhere in the stadium, hey, maybe even on the roof, the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit takes on the Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan. And Arn Anderson, one of the horsemen, of course, has said that the truth will come out in the Great American Bash. So much animosity between Chris Benoit and the Taskmaster. Oh, yeah.
And you see right here, Public Enemy brought out their plunder right here. This morning on the Pro, and the Armstrongs desperately need a win opportunity, knocking at their door one more time, but stay away from that plunder.
Well, you know, nice psychological advantage here. Bring that table out. You know, it's not illegal to bring out a table with you as long as you don't peg it inside the ring. But psychologically, the Armstrongs have to be looking over there saying, oh, man, we're in there with a couple of guys who are insane. Stay away from that table. But if they do, they'll be out of ring positioning. So it's a good psychological chess move by the Public Enemy.
Well, speaking of tables, I think real quickly, the table has been set for the Macho Man, Randy Savage. I'm talking about spontaneous combustion, crazed dogs on his side. Coach Capers, great NFL coach, has to be worried about that situation. But I believe the Macho Man, Randy Savage, will out-coach Bobby the Brain Heenan at this Great American Bash, only on pay-per-view.
Well, look at Savage, I should call him Mr. Bonaparte, is going to run into his Waterloo and standing on the boat with his hand up
Bonaparte.
Like George Washington, will be a fearless guiding light leader, Mr. Bobby Heenan.
Ooh.
The U.S. title will also be defended by Conan against El Gato, and
whoa,
it is Sting against Lord Steven Regal. We saw this past Monday at Nitro. Sting came in during a match with Lord Steven Regal and just backhanded him, slapped him, just like Regal slapped Sting. A lot of heat in that match, Sting against Lord Steven Regal.
The Armstrongs are getting railroaded right here, too. I guarantee you, they're out there in no man's land. That's not where they want to be with Public Enemy. And you see him grabbing him by the hand. I know where he's taking him. He's getting over by that plunder, trying to get him ready for the big pop-up.
Yeah, he's not taking him there to buy him lunch.
You know, also at the match, let's not forget, Diamond Ellis Page, the Lord of the Ring, against Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
It's loaded. It's loaded.
Man, is it loaded. All right, and you see Scotty Armstrong, who is laying flat on his back. And Rocco Rock goes for Steve Armstrong and levels it.
You trapped him in the corner. Steve Armstrong caught off guard. And here goes Rocco. You know what he's doing, but he's taking some time here.
Getting ready. Sure.
He's up. He's over.
Oh! Armstrong saw him coming, tried to move out of the way.
Well, that was a good thing by the Public Enemy right there. Whoa, watch out.
Don't let him do that.
Man, he drove him right down in there on his throat.
Wow, like a guillotine. Man, oh, man.
Well, the Armstrong, they've hit a buzzsaw out here. I'll guarantee you.
All right, Rocco Rock and Johnny Crunch doing so well this morning here on the Pro against the Armstrong brothers. And Scotty, a scoop slam and flat on his back. And Johnny Crunch, I guess, just gets him set up for whatever he wants.
I don't know, they got something going on. Unique tag team right here. Public Enemy with unique combinations. And here's one of them.
Caught him on a drive.
One, two, and three. You know, we talked a lot about Arn Anderson. He's going to be in action tonight on WCW Saturday night. So is the Giant. We'll see the U.S. champ Conan. We've talked a lot about the Steiners as well. Everybody warming up for the Great American Bash. The Steiners take on the Harlem Heat as they head into that match with Fire and Ice, in the match in which there must be a winner at the Great American Bash. Then Rick Steiner and Scott Steiner in individual action on Nitro. We're back with more in a moment. Can you believe it? Back in the control center, the eve of the Great American Bash, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. And as you know, it's only available on pay-per-view. Oh my, Bobby the Brain Heenan now will manage Ric Flair and Art Anderson as they tag to meet the NFL past and present.
Steve Bongo McMichael and Kevin Green with the acrimonious Macho Man Randy Savage in their corner. Savage, of course, has been suspended as a wrestler. He makes Albert Bell and Claude Lemieux look like a couple of Sunday school kids. But Savage will be allowed to manage Green and McMichael. This should be one of the greatest tag matches in professional wrestling history. Hey, the biggest WCW heavyweight champion of all time, the 7'4", 474-pound giant, will be defending against challenger of the total package, Lex Luger. Jimmy Hart will be in the Giant's corner. In other action, cruiserweight champion Dean Malenko to meet Rey Mysterio Jr. Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan squares off with Chris Benoit and Falls Count Anywhere. U.S. champ Conan to defend against El Gato. Plus, Diamond Dallas Page locks up with Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Get Sting goes one-on-one with Lord Steven Regal. I expect a total explosion when these two men hit the ring. As you know, two men issued a challenge to WCW this past Monday. Tomorrow night at the Great American Bash, we'll find out if that challenge will be accepted, and if so, where and when the match would take place. Call your cable company. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier, 1-800-843-9266. DirecTV, 1-800-347-3288. Whatever you do tomorrow night, it's Father's Day. Don't miss the Great American Bash, starting at 7 o'clock, live from Baltimore, Maryland.
Back to action at our main event here on WCW Pro on a Great American Bash weekend. Cruise along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the living legend, Larry Zbysko. We're here on the Pro on TBS this morning, and Scotty Riggs, the challenge of his career against the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, as Ric Flair heads into the Great American Bash. He and Arn Anderson, coached by Bobby the Brain Heenan, taking on Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green, coached by Randy Macho Man Savage. And Dusty, why don't we give the big news? I am just busting with it.
Well, I'll tell you what, speaking of big news, the Macho Man Randy Savage, we talked about him earlier, and I know you got big news, but right here on the Pro this morning, Riggs has an opportunity to knock it his window for the Nature Boy Ric Flair. Will he catch him off guard? Is Ric Flair thinking so much about the Great American Bash on pay-per-view tomorrow night that he can let this thing slip by? And I guarantee you one thing, the Nature Boy got a lot on his mind, and more is coming.
Indeed it is.
What do you mean more is coming?
Well, here's the news.
Wait, let's wait till we come back.
We know that
Larry
don't know. Larry, you don't know.
As of this Monday night, the Macho Man Randy Savage's suspension from televised wrestling is over.
Evil woman.
Now look at this. Look at this. Here comes Ric Flair out with the women. Does he hide in the back? Does he cower? Is he hiding behind a skirt-selling woman and Miss Elizabeth out to beg Steve McMichaels for forgiveness?
Stop it.
No. This is what a real man.
Medicine here, I guarantee you. You talk about devilish women. Bottom line, Great American Bash on pay-per-view. And Chris, should we tell him now? Or we'll tell him during the break or when we come back.
We're going to take a very quick break, Dusty, but when we come back, blockbuster news.
Big news.
Almost as big as the Great American Bash. What a hot and loaded lineup we got for Nitro the night after the bash, this Monday night.
Wait, but let me guess. Dumbo McMichaels is dressing up like his wife in a dress, so Flair and R can't find him.
Maybe.
But I figured.
All your cable company fans, make sure you're part of the Great American Bash on Father's Day. What a tremendous gift that is. Back with that news about the Macho Man in a moment. Time for our main event here on WCW Pro, and Ric Flair looks happy. He is headed into the Great American Bash, and whatever the outcome of the match featuring him and his partner Arn Anderson, coached by Bobby Heenan, and Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green, coached by Randy Macho Man Savage. Listen to this, fans. Monday night, live on WCW Monday Nitro. Since Randy Macho Man Savage's suspension has been lifted, it's the Macho Man Randy Savage against the Nature Boy,
yes.
Ric Flair.
Yes.
Oh, that's too quick.
Yes.
That's too quick after the Great American Bash. That's too quick.
I like it.
Only. I know Macho Man's insane, but that's still too quick.
Hey, this is where the big boys play. After all, if WCW doesn't do it, who will? We are bringing you all the action live on Monday Nitro. Man, oh man, is that gonna be hot.
I'll tell you what, that will give incentive, if you will, to the Macho Man Randy Savage going to the Great American Bash. Only on pay-per-view, pick up a telephone, call somebody about this situation. Can he coach these two athletes, these two football players, against Bobby the Brain Heenan, one of the greatest managers of all time, and Iron Anderson, Nature Boy Ric Flair? Can you imagine what is going through Mongo McMichael's mind after Ric Flair had played the mind games with the lovely Deborah, and all the lies have been laid out on the table about her and the Nature Boy Ric Flair?
Yeah, I know it's going through Dumbo's mind. Now he's hiding behind his mother-in-law's dress, seeing his wife's begging for mercy. Apparently didn't work. The jerk realized he opened his big mouth, he made a mistake. He should just let his wife run off with Ric Flair and live happily ever after. Instead, he's going to ruin his life and end the career of Kevin Green.
Let's not forget this past WCW Monday Nitro. It was supposed to be Arn Anderson and the Nature Boy Ric Flair against Joe Gomez and the Renegade. Joe Gomez was supposed to have made his debut. Instead, they were attacked by Flair and Anderson. Sting and Lex Luger then agreed to wrestle Ric Flair and Arn Anderson. And as we saw, right in the middle of it, out came the Giant to interfere in that match, but he was pummeled by Sting, Lex Luger, and Scotty Steiner.
You know, when you talk about the Great American Bash and that matchup at pay-per-view tomorrow night, everybody's talking about all the different combustion situations getting ready to explode. One very important situation, though, that most question asked, if he is to stand a chance, Lex Luger against the Giant, if he is to stand an opportunity to gain the world's heavyweight title, he will have to get him in a situation to get almost 500 pounds of 7'4" up in the rack. Many say he can, many say he can't, but you ain't gonna find out unless you buy the hottest pay-per-view ever in the history of WCW.
It's a backslide to Al Flair, almost a one. I beg your pardon, almost a three.
Yeah, but Riggs didn't have enough pressure on his shoulder, didn't have him arms locked right. Look at that. Turn around, Ric Flair right there. Talk about being crisp. Talk about being sharp. Talk about being ready. Talk about having a heyday with two big, dumb, stupid football players. Oh! All I can predict is Ric Flair is going to be spending Dumbo McMichael's alimony by Monday.
So many undercurrents in this match, Dusty. Bobby the Brain Heenan saying, emphasizing to Randy Macho Man Savage, don't touch me. I have no beef with you. You should have no beef with me. What's going on there? And as we said, Savage is looking forward to dealing with the Nature Boy Ric Flair at Nitro.
Well, Bobby the Brain Heenan is standing out in the middle of a field, and that's a raging rhino running at him with crazed look in his eye. And he's going to say, don't touch me. Let me tell you something. If these guys aren't prepared, Arn Anderson, Nature Boy Ric Flair, and Bobby Heenan, for an onslaught, for a rush, if you will, for a complete crazed dog attitude, they are going to the wrong arena tomorrow night on pay-per-view at the Great American Bash. Because I guarantee you, the Macho Man will come out and have these guys smoking, like it or not. Two great athletes against two great athletes that are professional wrestlers.
It's going to be just like Alex Karras. He shot off his mouth, had one match, and limped home crying like a baby.
I tell you what, legend, you're just beating that to death.
Can you imagine? You say, here's dad, here's a tie for Mother's Day, oh thanks. Here's some underwear, oh thanks. Here's some socks, oh thanks. But if you say, dad, here's the Great American Bash, thank you. You're the best son, you're the best daughter a father could ever have. The Great American Bash live and only on pay-per-view tomorrow night.
Well, look at this. The Flair out there dancing his way back out into the ring. You know, we are talking about so much this explosive situation and have not really overlooked the fact that Scotty Riggs has really got an opportunity knocking at his door right here and is taking it to the Nature Boy. Look at that. Looking good, but devilish women underneath them. Beautiful black sequin gowns. I'm telling you, devilish, devilish women. And they will be devilish tomorrow.
Look at between them and Ric Flair playing mind games right here with Scotty Riggs. Already looks confused. Look at that. Flair caught him off guard again. Riggs doesn't know if he's coming or going.
Oh, reverse knife edge chop. And indeed, Riggs has taken so much punishment at the hands of the 13-time heavyweight champion of the world, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Now the shove off there on Riggs. Shoulder block, football tackle. And Flair goes down. Riggs up and over. And an elbow. And Riggs, what's he going to do? He flies outside the ring. Man, hey, look out. There's woman. Get her away from him. Get her away.
She grabbed him by the eyeballs right there. Got the thumbs in the socket.
And he's having a blurred vision right now. But the Ninja Boy Ric Flair strutting. You know, he reminds me right here strutting a little bit. I don't know if going into this thing, and we just gave the announcement. And I know, Chris, you have been on the horn in the truck. And our great producer Woody was talking about negotiations going on about Nitro and the Macho Man. Do you think that the Ninja Boy Ric Flair doesn't know yet that the Macho Man and the Sun will meet him at Nitro live Monday for 2 hours? He's kind of carefreeing about this thing. See what I'm saying? I mean, will that explode maybe this morning, later on, or about noon today when he finds out going into night on Saturday night? We could have an explosive Saturday night.
Oh, indeed we will. The Giant will be there in action. Arn Anderson. We're going to see the Steiners against the Harlem Heat tonight right here on TBS. And we'll talk a lot more about any late breaking news from the Great American Bash. Obviously, at the Bash, we are going to have that announcement as to whether WCW will accept, when, where, and how we'll accept the challenge for those two guys who had the gall to come down here and challenge World Championship Wrestling. Also, make sure to tune into the main event live at 6:05 tomorrow night here on TBS.
Yeah.
And indeed, the gall of those two. As we said, since 1905, we've had a history here in this company. And nobody can challenge World Championship Wrestling when it comes to history, honor, and pride. And one of those responsible for that, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. He's being brought now by Scotty Riggs.
Well, Rick's fighting for his life. I think Rick is feeling the opportunity of a lifetime slipping through his fingers. He better make his move. He got Flair one right there, right in the face.
And Flair is wobbly, and the whip now, and Riggs.
Oh. Missed it. He missed it.
Wow, did he ever.
Well, I tell you what, when you're in a situation like this, you can't make a mistake against the Nature Boy Ric Flair.
There you go. Oh, he got his head around.
Package 1, 2, and almost a 3. The inside cradle didn't work.
Right there, hard to keep Flair down. This guy's already breaking pressures on the way down before you roll him over and cradle him up. Again, got Riggs in the corner. Riggs better fight out of there.
Oh. Whoa, baby.
Went right down and now backs off. And gentlemen, I think you'd agree.
But he's biding time. He's biding time here. Riggs is 4-on-4.
What would we agree about?
We don't agree.
That he was biding time. High back body drop and Flair flat on his back. And Riggs is on a roll. Lateral press. 1, 2, and a half. And Flair kicks out. The back's off again. And Riggs, he's falling for it.
And Flair's a master of this mental game of chess. Look, found an opening. Almost makes it look easy. Just makes his own openings. I hope Dumbo McMichaels and Kevin Green are hiding behind the women's studs. They're going to be two scared individuals tomorrow, brother.
They are pumped after months of training. They've got a lot of pride themselves.
Oh, he caught him up there.
He sure did, and Flair is saying, no. He's even grabbing the hair of Riggs, but to no effect, and he's flat on his back.
Can Riggs put him away, though? That's what he's got to do right there, where he cranked him in, got him up high for the ride.
Wow, did he ever. And a beautiful drop kick. No one can do it like Scotty Riggs.
Yeah, but can he keep it going? One move's not enough. No!
Went for a flying forearm there, and he missed that thing. Two mistakes he's made in the last 4 or 5 minutes right here. Somewhere they will come back to haunt you when the Nature Boy Ric Flair takes over in a situation like this. Will the Macho Man let Michaels and Green make mistakes? I don't think so. I think they're going to come at him like I said before, craved off, brother.
Well, Flair has already made it known he's going to go for the knees, and what a threat that is to anyone playing in the NFL. It's going to be a tremendous night tomorrow night, live and only on pay-per-view, and Riggs is a...
Whoa! Speaking of knees,
he broke his neck!
Man, what an unbelievable shot that was. Got him hooked up in the figure four. This thing is over, brother. I guarantee you that.
Hey, I hope that coach Don Capers is watching this. Because when Green's knees get in the figure four, he's not going to run for anybody.
All right, what a tremendous WCW pro it has been. The Nature Boy, Ric Flair, victorious over Scotty Riggs with that figure four leg lock. Tonight, Conan against Kurosawa. We'll see the Steiners against Harlem Heat on WCW Saturday night. Of course, we've got the Great American Bash. We've got the live main event tomorrow night preceding the Great American Bash. Make that call and be a part of the Bash. The world title on the line. The Giant against Lex Luger. Ric Flair and Arn Anderson with Bobby Heenan against Steve Mongo McMichael and Kevin Green with Randy Macho Man Savage in their corner. And then the following night, it's WCW Monday Nitro fans. We'll see you tomorrow night at the...
Big God.
Well, I want to welcome everybody to the Pro this morning right here on TBS. So much to talk about. Hostile takeover. Eric Bischoff laid to waste. Is WCW rebounding from this? Obviously, we did. I-3 have been chosen. War has been declared. Bash at the beach right around the corner. I'll tell you what, guys. I cannot wait to get this thing on.
Uranium 235 and plutonium are going to meet at the Bash at the beach. What an explosion it will be between us and them. Not to mention the Dungeon of Doom and Arn Anderson and Benoit. Talk about war.
That's right. In fact, we just saw Chris Benoit, and in fact, stills from the Great American Bash. Chris Benoit, as he took on the Taskmaster Kevin Sullivan in that devastating Falls Count Anywhere match. Well, that went anywhere, including into the men's room. And as we saw then, Arn Anderson attacking the Taskmaster tonight on WCW Saturday Night, in addition to Harlem Heat against Fire and Ice, and Arn Anderson and Chris Benoit against, hang on, the Rock and Roll Express, Dusty. We're going to see actual footage from the Great American Bash. And those two big interlopers, interrupters, attack Eric Bischoff.
Unprecedented in the annals of WCW, what we'll be seeing tonight at WCW Saturday Night, because of the importance of the situation with the executive producer and our colleague Eric Bischoff, and what went down, and desperate people doing desperate deeds in desperate time. And this past Nitro, we stood up on our haunches, brother, and said, come on, let's get this thing going. So Bash at the Beach, July the 7th, Tony Schiavone, Silver Tony VSS, most important pay-per-view in the history of WCW.
Billy Kidman now backed up by Jushin Thunder Liger. You know, who the heck do they think they are coming into World Championship Wrestling challenging us? Who do they think they are?
Well, they're going to find out. There ain't nobody.
And look at Liger now. He is manhandling Billy Kidman, who is so impressed. So many people who are watching professional wrestling throughout the world. This young man, not great in stature, but he can keep up with Liger.
He's got movement. He doesn't have the experience, though, or the ability. I don't think Liger does. Liger here, sensational athlete. Of course, you got Sonny Ono out there giving this man advice. And right there, nice little leg scissors across the head of Kidman, is trying to twist out of it. But Liger, a little bit more weight, too.
Also coming up tonight on WCW Saturday Night, something we don't see very often anymore in professional wrestling, a woman's match right here on TBS. Keeping up with Jushin Thunder Liger, who is certainly a legend in professional wrestling in Japan. Up and over. Oh, man, and he flattens Kidman.
Look at the momentum he got there. But again, you know, worldwide experience is... Oh, Kidman kicked out. Worldwide experience is something Kidman doesn't have and Liger does. And that just comes with years and years of flying all over the world, wrestling all kinds of international style. Dumped him right in the back of his head.
Almost a brain buster right there. Dumped him on his head. Jushin Thunder Liger. Got to agree with Larry. The legendary Zabisco in the situation right here. He is dead. Liger does have the experience, but Kidman is a real comer. But we've seen so much animosity just recently transpired at WCW that, as Larry said even earlier with the Taskmaster, Dungeon of Doom, and the Horseman, war has been declared by basically everybody.
And we got a new horseman, too, who's a $500,000 pitcher.
Yeah, I was going to bring that up.
That's the man
that you call Dummy. That's the man that you call Dummy McMichaels. That's the man that you really just pushed into a corner to where I looked at you the next day and you had eggs all over your face, brother.
I have egg on my face. Well, you know, the only thing is, though, I think his wife kept the $500,000.
And gave him the T-shirt.
And Mongo kept the T-shirt.
I knew you were going to say that.
Kidman now, flying lariat. And I can't believe it. Billy Kidman, a virtual nobody, is coming close to defeating Jushin Thunder Liger.
Right here, what a big boy play. What a victory that would be for him right here. And I know Liger doesn't want to take this thing back to Japan with a loss. But Larry, I'm going on back to that situation. I don't want to keep loving it in on you, but you had really downplayed.
I didn't realize you were just smart.
Nice
shot.
Man, defying gravity, gets 1-2 and almost 3 on Liger. What a showing from Billy Kidman.
But I think even to take a phrase from you this past Monday night when you said the Horsemen were really back in full force like you've never seen them on Nitro when you had talked about that situation. That is so true. I believe they just relit a kindling and made it into a big bonfire. Once again, the Horsemen
truly are back at WCW.
And now Jushin's under a lager, realizing that Kidman is not a young man to be messed with. I think he's going to try to finish him off here. He's got him off. A superplex, it looks like, off the top rope. Beautiful execution there by Jushin Thunder Liger.
Yeah, Liger just whipped this kid down. What momentum, what gravity. And Kidman, not all that bulky, so he feels everything.
Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster, the Great American Bash, took a superplex by Benoit as well. Nice splash there, and that should do it. Gets one, two, and three there for Jushin Thunder Liger on Billy Kidman.
Well, Kidman gave it an effort, just putting out to Jushin Thunder Liger. Works right there with the influence of Mr. Sonny Ono all the way from Japan. Liger, extraordinary athlete. Take a look at Mr. Kidman, though. I mean, he gave it his best effort, gave it a shot. Didn't have the weight, I don't think, to make moves like this. Very effective. Watch this, just kind of reverse moonsaults on Liger. But again, doesn't have enough weight to knock the wind out of him. Liger retaliates, come back, drives hard into the chest of Kidman. Again, Billy Kidman, product of the power plant, but Liger, product of worldwide experience. One thing, Chris, money can't buy.
We're back with more here on WCW Pro on TBS. We'll take you back to last Monday's WCW Monday Nitro and a special announcement about the Nitro coming up this Monday night live on TNT. It is a triangle match involving three tag teams. That and a lot more right after this on TBS. Did it at the Great American Bash. And they did it at Nitro. We take you back now to Nitro.
And Sting.
Hi again, folks. After one incredible week, we're back in the control center on our way to World Championship Wrestling Super Summer Sizzler, the Bash at the Beach, Sunday, July 7th, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, 4 out of the West Coast, live from Daytona Beach and available only on pay-per-view. Call right now regarding availability. Now then, here's that gigantic announcement of monumental interest to wrestling fans all over the world. These outsiders that recently arrived at World Championship Wrestling, challenging people, pushing officials around, well, their challenge has finally been answered. These two men plus their mystery partner now will be facing WCW's elite. Lex Luger, the total package. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, who's really a madman, and one of the greatest wrestlers in the world today, Sting. I'm going to have more on that big six-man tag later in this program. In other action, United States champ Conan defends against the 13-time WCW heavyweight champ, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, with Woman Elizabeth and maybe the supporting cast from Showgirls. Also, here's another what I'd call grudge match. The WCW heavyweight champ, the Giant, and the Taskmaster, Kevin Sullivan, with Jimmy Hart, to meet the Horsemen, Arn Anderson and Chris Benoit. Get this, if the Horsemen win, they'll get another shot at the world title. Plus, there's going to be a whole lot more that I'll talk about later in this program here on TBS. It's all going to happen with the sun, the sand, the action, and the intrigue at the Bash at the Beach. We're just about 2 weeks out, Sunday, July the 7th, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, 4 out of the West Coast, and available exclusively on pay-per-view. Ladies and gentlemen, get on the phone right now and make that all-important telephone call. Don't miss the Bash at the Beach. And gentlemen, the Disco Inferno, who we're about to see, gets his shot, his biggest shot of his entire young career against the Cruiserweight champion, Dean Malenko, coming up in 2 weeks and a day, Sunday, July 7th, at Bash at the Beach.
Now, Disco Inferno going to have a hard time dancing around wearing that gold if he can take it off the waist of the man of a thousand holds. Disco better not worry about his hairdo once he gets in the ring with Mr. Malenko.
I'll tell you what, guys, it is an angry night. Coming up on July the 7th at Bash at the Beach, we're talking war declared, hostile takeovers. We spoke so much already about that situation with them guys and who is the third member. We talked about the men that were chosen to represent WCW. But I guarantee you there's other involvements that are war on that thing. Taskmaster Giant,
dungeon of doom, and the Hawksmen declared war also against each other.
Well, and we're going to see that situation.
We sure are. Arn Anderson and the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit facing the Giant and the Taskmaster at the Bash at the Beach. And if the Horsemen win that match, one of the Horsemen gets a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship. As usual, the Horsemen keeping things very close to the
vest. I want to ask Larry the Legend, who... It didn't say which Hoffman, who would get that shot at the World's Heavyweight title if they were to win that thing, which is a big if.
Well, I would think it would be Arn Anderson, the bigger man of the two, the more experienced man of the
Hoffman,
two.
But they said Hoffman, Larry. They said all four of them, of the four. Read my lip, of the four, not of the two. Who, if they win that match, the Hoffman, will it be Nature Boy Ric Flair?
You say it again. I think Arn Anderson, the biggest of the Horsemen, more experienced. I don't think it's going to be Nature Boy Ric Flair. Ric Flair, he's got a big match coming up against Conan for the U.S. title. I think it's going to be the Enforcer if that happens.
Yeah, I want to make, yeah, all I was asking you was just to clarify because of the problem you had with the running dummy, if you will, Mongo McMichael, where you ate a little crow in that situation. Now, who the Hawks? I just want to make sure now that I get clarify your statement going in to bash at the beach.
Watch my lips. Arn Anderson.
I got you. That's all I wanted to hear.
As long as we got our lips together. Not together.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah.
Oh, yuck.
Yuck.
Ah. We're back to the action here on WCW Pro. A jam-packed arena at the MGM Studios.
Yeah, and you know, Disco Inferno, he, like you said, he's got to really focus on what's going on as we get ready to prepare for Battle Beach. WCW Monday Nitro coming up live 2 hours. Going to be on fire this Monday night. Big triangle match. I know you're going to talk about that. But what a treat we got on Saturday night tonight. The Mothership. The women are in town. I'm talking about Medusa and Debbie Combs going to get it all on WCW Saturday night.
Indeed, Debbie Combs, an extraordinary talent, as is Medusa, and we have not seen Debbie for a long time. We are so looking forward to it tonight, as well as, of course, as we said, the actual footage from the Great American Bash in which Eric Bischoff got attacked, essentially powerbombed through a part of the stage, and Johnny Boone clotheslines himself, almost a guillotine on the top rope.
We're looking at flying cross body against Disco, but Disco can move. He's got movement. You got to be careful what you do against this guy. Personally, if Disco wasn't so focused on his own hair, he'd be much better than that win-loss record.
Well, he's got an opportunity. Yeah, Eric, we talked about the executive producer, Eric Bischoff, and what happened. And when Waller declared, desperate men doing desperate deeds. And tonight on Saturday night, we'll take a hard, cold look at that thing as we are this morning as we get ready for Bash at the Beach. And our colleague, Tony Bunny, said the most important pay-per-view in the history of WCW and probably of all pay-per-views is Bash at the Beach coming up on July the 7th.
Yeah, it's going to be a historical marker in professional wrestling. And is Bischoff still living?
Yeah. Yeah, he is. And that's the take on that. I'm going to tell the fans tonight on Saturday night. That's the take on that. You know, Eric Bischoff, a black belt karate, trains all the time. I mean, a normal man might not be moving around today. And he's not moving too well anyway as it is.
Disco Inferno moving very well right now. Though on Johnny Boone, and this should be it. Disco looking real good this morning. Here on the Pro, 1, 2, and 3, and he's got it. Also tonight, Conan is taking on VK Wall Street. Conan, the U.S. champ. He is going into Bash at the Beach, defending that U.S. championship against the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Harlem Heat tonight against Fire and Ice, and a whole lot more, including the Horsemen, all on Saturday night. And we'll be talking about Nitro as well. Hang on, because Nitro, as usual, is on a roll. Two great solid hours live on TNT.
We are setting the war zone this morning on the Pro on TBS.
We got our camouflage paint on. We got the camis on. We are locked. We are cocked. We are ready to roll. And Johnny Boone will see this again.
Right there, Disco Inferno dumped him back. Good ring position. Caught him right underneath the throw. That knocked the wind out of this kid. Disco dumped him again. And, of course, nice swinging neck breaker. But the Inferno can move. Going to have a test of a lifetime against the man of 1,000 holes. It's a bad. That's a beast.
VK Wall Street beating Conan tonight on WCW Saturday night. We'll see him in action. And a whole lot more about Bash at the Beach and Nitro after this on TBS. We're back to action here on WCW Pro on TBS. It's BK Wall Street against Steve Armstrong, and BK getting ready for his big match tonight.
WCW Saturday Night against Conan, 6:05 Eastern, right here on TBS.
Right here on the mothership, you're so right. Steve Armstrong, we've documented his trail to this ring on so many occasions. Victory so close to him in most cases, but right here, BK Wall Street, just when I want to go back and ask Larry another question. I want to make sure that I clarify Larry.
You're not going
to
get off this, are you?
No, I just want to, when I ask you, I just want to make sure I'm talking about the right thing so we understand it as it comes into full focus. Okay, these two guys, you know what I mean? The one say the big guy and the medium-sized guy. And we got another guy. We went and chose our guys. We off the wall, bash at the beat. Speculation running wild on who that third guy is. Don't you think that will really have an impact on how we prepare for that situation? Shouldn't we know that? Will we find out tonight? Will we find out from you on Nitro? Tell me.
The way these two guys came out, I mean, you know, throwing little Bischoff around, that's not very impressive. I don't think they got the guts to say who the third man is. I think they want to try to keep it a surprise. I mean, we know Lex Luger, Savage is still nuts anyway, and Sting, they don't care who the third man is.
Yeah, I just don't think
the other two cowards got the guts to say who the third man is, but I don't think it matters.
I don't think, and another thing I agree with you on is I don't believe either that the situation that they are in, that they want to dictate or tell us, because they're throwing us off. They're still trying that hostile takeover. When you go to take over a company and hostile takeover, you don't give them all your game plan right off, right or wrong. But all I'm saying on this Monday night, we're coming up 2 hours on TNT, this hot show, Larry, that you are right on there with a silver tongue punch around it. Are you maybe going to come with some news? Maybe you find out between now and then.
You'll be the last to know.
I figured that.
Well, personally, yeah. They both thought I'd just go back to where they came from. Coming up this Monday on Monday Nitro, 8 p.m. Eastern, here on TNT, not here, but on our sister network, TNT. Here's the announcement we were telling you about, that special triangle match with three tag teams, the Harlem Heat, Lex Luger and Sting, of course, the World Tag Team Champions, and the Steiners. That's right, the Steiners, Harlem Heat, Lex Luger and Sting, this Monday on Nitro. Man, oh man, 2 hours long. And now Wall Street, who is getting ready for his match against the U.S. champ, Conan tonight on WCW Saturday Night, about to be pinned by Steve Armstrong, and picks out Armstrong, hits that takeover, and sends Wall Street flying.
Wow, nice move right there. Armstrong fired up, understanding the possibility here.
Fired up, but there's the curse of the Armstrongs. Follow this man into the ring. You know, we talk about the Armstrongs, how good they are, but what a problem they have scoring victories. And Wall Street, not an easy man to beat. Steve Armstrong right there hits a nice move, but looks a little befuddled.
Hey, get your hands off me.
Well, we talked about Conan. Conan also at the Bash of the Beach Sunday, I beg your pardon.
Take your
July
mind
7th. Takes on the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Make the phone call to the friendly folks at your local cable company and make sure that you are a part of Bash at the Beach only on pay-per-view.
But Armstrong had a chance right there. Wall Street looked at the crowd. Armstrong should have been on him. Got to get aggressive. Maybe that would break the curse that's on the Armstrong. They're not aggressive enough. You know, nice guys finish last.
So I've heard. Armstrong goes flying. I reminded, of course, that match with Conan. Ric Flair is for the U.S. Heavyweight Championship. Now, that title, the U.S. Heavyweight Championship, held by Ric Flair, his first major title, it propelled him to the World Heavyweight Championship. Dusty, you were there, and you know that.
The Hartsman situation now at the Great American Bash was they all got together, got a new member. Larry Zbyszko didn't pick him, obviously, but got a new member, and a lot of money was thrown around right there. But the bottom line is now they got to go, and they want all the gold. They want it all. They got to start with the U.S. title. That's the number two title, brother. That puts you in line for the World Heavyweight title. And the Nature Boy Ric Flair going for that. I don't see anything but strategy by the Hawkman. But, man, I guarantee you, the Dungeon of Doom will not take this line down. And Hulk Hogan is somewhere watching this whole thing transpire. His hat was in the ring. He throwed his name in the ring. I guarantee you this thing. Wow, what a wall this will be. Hostile takeover.
Steve McMichael in individual competition at the Bash at the Beach. That was a good shot.
Leverage
he got in there. On you, Larry. There is an abdominal stretch there by...
Who got a good shot in it, man?
Dusty did.
What shot was that?
It's about Steve McMichael. You were way out on a limb, and Dusty scored you right off.
What do you mean I was out on a limb?
Oh, all the names you called him, and all of a sudden now he's your friend.
He's not my friend. I just didn't realize the guy had half a brain, but it could have been his wife.
Look at this. A roll up by Steve Armstrong. The crowd is going nuts. Almost a three count, and Wall Street blocks him with a right and levels Armstrong.
See, again, Wall Street explodes a lot more aggressive right there, but again, could be McMichael's wife that's the brains of the outfit. She's the one that came out with the half a mil, gave the big dummy a T-shirt.
Right there, you know where that money come from.
Yeah.
I guarantee
Macho
you that.
Macho Man!
Yeah, Macho Man money.
Also, Rey Mysterio Jr., who has taken World Championship Wrestling by storm to face Psychosis. That's right, Mysterio against Psychosis at Bash at the Beach. Make sure you are able to make that call to your local cable company. A couple of relatively small men, but what power, what energy, what charisma. It could be the show stealer. And now the elbow there by Steve Armstrong. Oh, it lifts the knee, does BK Wall Street.
A couple of aggressive moves by Steve Armstrong. Doesn't follow it up successfully. Wall Street cuts him off. This could be it. Not kicked out.
I'll give you my opinion on that. The show stealer, sometimes you will say that in different occasions, but this Bash at the Beach, my friend, that is one thing the whole world will be watching, the one thing that everybody be buying this pay-per-view about, and that is the hostile takeover, and that is that situation with them two guys, not naming that third guy, but bottom line is we chose Oz, and we're talking Luger Steen and the Macho Man Randy Savage, WCW, most important pay-per-view to date.
You know, we talk a lot about what if, but imagine, let's imagine, if you will, that it's Monday, July 8th. You have forgotten to buy the Match of the Beach. That's humiliation. That's embarrassment. Don't make that mistake. Make sure you buy the pay-per-view, possibly the biggest in history here in World Championship Wrestling in any wrestling organization. The whip now by Steve Armstrong. Beautiful lariat clocks Wall Street. What a competitive match this is this morning on the Pro. Reversal of the Irish whip. Armstrong, oh no.
He got caught, Lynn. He got caught.
Stock market crash.
Well, and that is going to do it. One, two, and three.
And the curse of the Armstrong befalls upon speed.
My name!
You tell him. BK Wall Street, hard man to beat now. Armstrong would hit a couple nice moves. Again, I think lacking aggressiveness, lack of offense, something that's not going to happen at Bash at the Beach. This pay-per-view, gentlemen, is going to change the course of history in the next century. Right here, Wall Street came up with an Armstrong, got him not quite high enough, not quite underneath the chin enough. Wall Street able to get back up and explode in Armstrong. Again, the more aggressive the man, the more victories he's going to compile.
2 weeks and a day away. It's Sunday, July 7th, live on pay-per-view, the Bash at the Beach. And we're back with the Nasty Boys against Public Enemy. Our main event here in the Pro, they'll be at the Bash in a four-man dog collar match. Back in a moment. Preview of the match we're going to see at the Bash of the Beach, Sunday, July 7th. It is the Nasty Boys in the main event here against Public Enemy. Although, at the Bash of the Beach, it's going to be a four-man dog collar match.
Well, the Nasty Boys, the Public Enemy, no love lost. I tell you what, legend, no love lost between these guys. Dog collar match, brutality at its best. And I guarantee it's Bash at the Beach, July 7th. But right here, we get an opportunity to see some really fighting, maybe clever, going on in this situation right here. Real quick update. Once again, got to say, got to look tonight on the mothership, the women for the first time. I'm talking about Medusa. Devin Cohn's going to get it on right there. Conan, Wall Street, Harlem Heat, Fine Eyes. The Rock and Roll Express is back. Can't wait for Saturday night. And maybe, Larry, if I don't have to wait till Nitro, we might find out who that third guy is tonight.
And we'll find out. And, of course, a unique situation here with the Nasty Boys, Public Enemy.
You're right. You got it right.
I know I'm right. I'm
You're still thinking
right.
about Dumbo McMichaels, right?
Well, I wouldn't call him Dumbo.
Got
a half a million and a T-shirt. But here, unique situation with the Public Enemy and the Nasty Boys right here. Mutual hatred growing over who's got the reputation for being the most wild, unpredictable team in WCW. Public Enemy thinks it's them. The Nasty Boys are upset about it. Look at these guys. They're coming out with their own table.
Balog and Michael to face Joe Gomez at Bash at the Beach. Also, this coming Monday on Nitro, the Steiners, Lex Luger and Sting, and the Harlem Heat in in a tag team triangle match and in a Lord of the Ring contest. Diamond Dallas Page faces Alex Wright. If he gets by Alex Wright, the Lord of the Ring, DDP, he is going to be there in a tape fist Lord of the Ring match at Bash of the Beach against Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And we have got this main event here on WCW Pro, Public Enemy against the Nasty Boys, coming up right after this quick break on TBS. Cruise the dream, the legend, the gentleman. Let's not forget tonight on WCW Saturday Night, as we're about to watch this main event, we're going to show you not stills, but actual footage from the Great American Bash when the big guy and the medium-sized guy, as they're calling themselves now, attacked Eric Bischoff and powerbombed him through the stage. A devastating maneuver, and Knobs attacks Johnny Grimes.
Yeah, you knew this thing was going to get up, going to get go. Yeah, unprecedented tonight on WCW Saturday Night. So much more information concerning Bash at the Beach and what will transpire. So much has already happened. You talk about walls going on, this wall right here in the ring. But how about John Tenta, Bubber, what a wall they're going to have at Bash at the Beach.
And a Carson City Silver Dollar match. This, of course, coming on the heels of Big Bubba attacking Big John Tenta with a sock full of coins. Just, I think they have knocked him out with those solid shots to the head.
There goes Rocco.
Right flat out of his back.
Yeah, this one has all the potential of exploding right before our eyes right here. Look at Sags. This guy has not a full deck. Neither do these guys. All fighting for the reputation of being the wildest tag team in the world.
Whoever thought that somebody could actually challenge the Nasty Boys for that appellation, but
you know,
indeed.
Look, the Public Enemy even smells as bad as the Nasty Boys.
You know, they brought their plunder out. They got the table, always bring the plunder. Nasty Boys always looking around, seeing where they can find plunder. And yes, eruption is the bottom line on this thing right here. I'm talking about war has been grown, battle lines, hostile takeover, Bash at the Beach, them and us. I'm ready to see this thing done.
It is 2 weeks and a day away. Mark it on your calendars, and as soon as the pro is over, get on the phone and call your local cable company, the friendly folks there at the company. In fact, call them now while you're watching this main event and say, I want Bash at the Beach. Don't be left out of the Bash. Don't find yourself on Monday, July 8th saying, what happened at the Bash? You gotta buy the pay-per-view as Johnny Grunge tags in Rocco Rock. Now the double whip on Brian Knobs, and a double elbow, and Knobs goes down.
Yeah, nice double teaming, nice tag team work. Public Enemy looking sharp here. Look at the position they got Brian Knobs in. That's the corner they want his body. Over there trying to get Sags frustrated, trying to suck him in so the referee gets drawn out of position. Sags wouldn't fall for it, but Knobs is in trouble.
And a solid right there by Rocco Rock. You're right, Larry. Knobs is in real trouble, and he comes up with a mule kick of sorts, but a kick of his own by Rocco Rock. In the rock corner is Brian Knobs. Jerry Sags needs to get in there and rescue Knobs. That's why we're going to see it. Bash at the Beach. These four guys in a dog collar match. Maybe we'll keep them all together.
There's a tag. Again, try to keep Brian Knobs in that corner. Wear down the one man. Don't let him tag Sags. They got him again.
Yeah, they got him coming off. And the offensive game plan of Public Enemy, if that's such a thing, with these four guys, is really coming into play right here as they have the Nasty Boys where they want them.
Another tag team match, of course, coming up at the Bash at the Beach Sunday, July 7th. It is the Giant and the Taskmaster against Chris Benoit, the Canadian Crippler, and Arn Anderson. If the Horsemen win that match, one of the four Horsemen get a shot. They get a shot at the World Heavyweight Champion. We'll see Arn Anderson and Chris Benoit tonight on WCW Saturday Night against none other than the Rock and Roll Express.
His neck snap back, runs down.
Almost rolled right into your living room.
No.
Uh-huh. Oh, boy.
The threatened pit stop. Here it comes. Anything nastier than this, I can't imagine. And the Nasty Boys are proud of this move.
Well, that just plain stinks right there.
Stinks from here.
That's got a smell about it, I guarantee it. That will get your whole equilibrium thrown off.
And Sags has got Johnny Grunge pinned here after the pit stop. 1-2, and Rocco Rock comes in for the rescue.
Yes, save the day. Grunge, he almost fainted of asphyxiation right there, but he got Sags back, because they can keep Sags in that corner. But now they're going to have to start all over again while Knobs is catching his breath.
Drapes his neck over the top table there and just snaps it down and back. and Johnny Grunge and Rock the Rock now have Fags in as much trouble as earlier. They had Brian Knobs. Does the Public Enemy have the Nasty Boys number? It sure looks like it.
Oh. Boy, so much for the pit stop.
Yeah. We are going to find out at the match at the beach if indeed the Public Enemy can take care of the Nasty Boys in that four-man dog collar match. Hey, also on Nitro, this coming Monday night on our sister network, TNT, it is Diamond Dallas Page against Alex Wright in a Lord of the Ring match. And in that triangle match, Lex Luger and Sting, Harlem Heat and Steiners, for the first time ever, that triangle match involving tag teams on Monday Nitro.
At the past pay-per-view of the Great American Bash, we've seen guys go up into the bathroom. I'm talking about Taskmaster, fought all over the building. You imagine these two guys at pay-per-view and Plunder will be a bomb. You could be able to find Plunder anywhere. Dog collar tied to your thing. This thing could be very, very exciting. And I guarantee you somebody will love to get hurt at Bash at the Beach, July the 7th, Daytona Beach, Florida.
The war is on.
Yes, it is.
They wanted a war. They accused us of wanting a war. I don't think so. They wanted a war. They challenged us. Oh! They asked for it, and they got it. And they're going to get it at the Bash like Rocco Rock just got it.
Yeah, where's he going? He ain't going anywhere.
Well, wherever he's going, he'll have a high pitch voice.
And Sags, is he gonna suplex him back in? Yes, he is, and he hangs on.
Wow! Yeah, but Sags gotta get up and cover him. Go for the pin. Rocco's hurt. He's got his opportunity.
He's trying to get over, trying to make a tag.
And he doesn't come anywhere close. He 360s Rocco Rock does Sags, and in comes Johnny Grunge with a big boot to the back of the head.
Well, he made a boot and he made a save. I guarantee you, boom.
I was going to say, Sags may be making a mistake. He had an opportunity to tag now before. He tagged him now, but it could be too late.
He missed him. Yeah, he went for it, but he missed him.
Good calling there.
The two fresh men.
It could be that too. That's
come
true.
In, and now that's the two blondes. Yeah. And it's Johnny Grunge, who is going to get battered by Brian Knobs. And he slows him down with a poke to the eyes and a right to the forehead.
Well, he got him stopped now.
Boom! And that slows down Grunge. What action we're having to the back of the neck. A flying elbow. This could be it. One, two, and again Rocco Rock breaks it up.
Saved again by Rocco Knobs. Hit him with that 310 pounds. Caught Rocco on the apron. And Grunge got him.
Got him with a thumb in the ass. Cut that thing off right there. Bash at the Beach. Wall's been declared. Hostile takeover. Cannot wait for this situation.
All right, folks, all this hour, we've been telling you about the great events coming up here, and this is probably the best summer in wrestling history. We've got WCW Saturday Night Tonight, actual footage from the Great American Bash, and Rocco Rock misses. We're going to see those two big guys, those interlopers, those interrupters, attack Eric Bischoff and powerbomb him through that stage from the Great American Bash. WCW Saturday Night Tonight, Medusa against Debbie Cole, and a whole lot more action than Nitro, and this action is unbelievable. And of course, call your local cable companies. Make sure you're a part of Bash at the Beach Sunday, July 7th, 2 weeks and a day away.
Well, Sam took on 2-2 long, but now came in as the equalizer, nailed Rocco and Johnny Grunge. Can they keep it going? All four men, they're in there now. This thing's going.
Well, we knew this was going to happen right here. You cannot you can't control them for long. I mean, they just break loose. I guarantee you they might fight all the way to the Bash at the Beach. Referee trying to get in there, but that ain't going to work. See you later.
Somebody has just hit the referee. We're running out of time. It looks like this match is going to have to be continued at the Bash at the Beach.
Whoa.
It's a dog collar match. Public Enemy against the Nasty Boys. The bell has rung. The referee's lost control. He is out of it. Wow.
Right there. He hit him with the table and everything.
That's it. I'm Cruz for the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, for living legend Larry Zbyszko. We'll see you next week.
In a big way. And that music stirs the blood of every red-blooded American boy and girl. As a matter of fact, not only does it remind you of the 4th of July, but the 7th of July, Bash at the Beach, available only on pay-per-view.
Many people say on July the 8th, a new regime, if you will be in wrestling. This pay-per-view, Bash at the Beach, sets the tone for the next century, if you will. Wrestling, as we know it, hostile takeover.
Bash at the Beach. We're going to talk so much about today. And Larry, let me tell you something. The three guys we got to remain focused and stay steady, brother, at this situation.
Well, we all know what happened to Lex Luger and Sting on Nitro. They lost the heavyweight tag team championships of the world. However, in this case, in a matter this big, of this much importance, it could wind up to be a blessing. They better be focused on the honor and reputation of world championship wrestling.
You know what, Stegley, and that's hard to, as an athlete, to say, well, I got to lose something to gain something.
Yes.
But the legend laid it out right. I mean, what's happening right here is they now turn their attention to this wall that was started by these two guys. Third guy, we don't even know who it is. And that's the key. It could be more. But I know one thing. It's called Hostile Takeover, only on pay-per-view, and it will be something that Bash to be. And right here, Hacksaw Duggan, he's going to be there too, Staggerly.
Oh, I can't believe that Diamond Dallas Page agreed to a taped fist match with Hacksaw Jim Duggan. There are some things you don't do. As the song goes, you don't pull on Superman's cape, and you don't spit on Lone Ranger, and you do not accept a taped fist match against Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
I don't know if Diamond Dallas did it wholeheartedly, but he was man enough to accept that that's the bottom line. Of course, I'm not sure what his mysterious benefactor has to say in all this, but Diamond Dallas Page, he can take care of himself. He's smart enough to stay away from those tape fists. He knows that Hacksaw Jim Duggan, that's about his only repertoire.
Yeah. I want to remind everybody that coming up later on in the program, we're going to show you exactly how the total package Lex Luger and Sting lost the World Tag Team Championship belts. And also a reminder coming up on Saturday night, as you say, Dream the Mothership, you're going to see our three guys. You will see Sting, Luger, and the Macho Man, Randy Savage, getting ready for action for Bash at the Beach.
Yeah, and you know, even going into Bash at the Beach, the wall lines were drawn at the Great American Bash, you know, with the Four Horsemen and also the Dungeon of Doom,
right.
Taskmaster, and the Giant, and Iron and Benoit. But more than that, guys, also involved in this Bash at the Beach situation, United States Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, go for the U.S. title.
Oh.
Well, I guarantee you, the Horsemen are loading up no matter what happens at this Hostile Takeover.
Well, Ric Flair chomping at the bit. He wants to get his hands, of course, on the Ultimate, the Heavyweight Championship. He can get a chance at that if Arn Anderson and Benoit beat the Giant and the Taskmaster, but Ric Flair could basically have two belts here. I'm rooting on Ric Flair. I think he can beat Conan.
Wait a minute. Let me see if I got this right. Ric Flair has an opportunity at Bash at the Beach to become the new U.S. heavyweight champion.
Exactly.
And he could also walk out of Daytona Beach as the challenger to the heavyweight championship of the world.
Number one contender.
Unbelievable. This guy just keeps walking in clover.
I tell you what, Top Gun now hanging in there with Hacksaw Jim Duggan and the Gambler in there. We see Teddy Long motivator. I talked to Teddy Long so much about this Hostile Takeover situation. He's a motivator.
He
actually said, I will go and sit and talk with Sting Luger, the Macho Man. Everybody did. Let's get together. Let's have a team meeting. Let's make this thing really happen. Because I'll tell you what, everybody's eyes are open. This pay-per-view will change the course of history as we know it.
I think Teddy Long's input is important. He is the motivator, the emancipator. He is the man with the plan. People listen to Teddy Long, wind up in a winner's circle.
Guys,
I'm telling you.
You're scaring me. Just keep Teddy Long out of this for now. Look what he did to Pittman. He softened him up.
What do you mean he softened him
Pittman
up?
Pittman used to be a lot more aggressive, a lot more tenacious. Teddy Long's philosophy, he instilled the most horrible thing you can in an athlete, and that is the thought of sportsmanship.
Now, wait a minute. As far as Craig Pitbull Pittman, what Teddy Long managed to do was instill something that Pittman knows better than anybody, and that's discipline. He came out of the USMC. He knows discipline, and he reacts well.
He even conned Pittman into tag-teaming up with Duggan.
We want to remind everybody that coming up also tonight, besides our Saturday night program on TNT, WCW is at the Civic Center in Philadelphia. That's right, we're going to be in the City of Brotherly Love, and tomorrow, the theater at Madison Square Garden, New York City.
Yeah, tonight right here on TBS, as you said, the Mothership Saturday night talking about so much. We'll talk about it also today. Pittman rams him right there. They got him going. There he goes with a big tackle. Got the stance. Got him.
Puts
him
up. 1-2-3. The combination of the battering ram and Jim Duggan. So, that's off the Top Gun.
Jim Duggan? He threw the Gambler out over the top rope. That should have been a disqualification. provocation.
You have to see it to call it. You have to see it to call it.
Hopefully,
why are you even carrying on about
hopefully
that?
Diamond Dallas Page will take care of Hacksaw at Bash at the Beach.
You talk about a couple of guys fixing their bayonets and getting ready for action. Look at these two guys as we all get ready for Bash at the Beach. Little law and order to a situation that a situation suddenly included McMichael Mongo.
You know, Steve McMichael, I don't think I've ever been as disappointed or let down by any one human being as much as you've let me down. You know, I followed your career from the world champion Chicago Bears, all-pro NFL career, to you here in WCW as a rookie announcer, both of us rookies for World Championship Wrestling, highlight of my life. I thought you'd befriended me. I thought there was a kindred spirit there, both of us rookies here in this huge organization, the greatest organization. You showed me your true colors when I went to your wife's aid to defend her honor, to defend the McMichael name, and all it got me was a concussion and my partner, a trip to the hospital. Well, Steve McMichael, you really, really showed me your true colors. You showed me that you belong with that pack of dogs of horsemen with your actions this Monday night on Nitro. And July 7th at Bash on the Beach, Steve, we're going to have an opportunity, two rookies, to tie it up head-to-head. And we're going to be able to find out who the better rookie is. Man-to-man, July 7th at Bash on the Beach.
Desperado.
You okay?
I'm fine.
But you're getting sick.
No. I was getting ready to make a song styling entree for Los Dos Hombres Muy Malo, Desperado, Joe Gomez y Manny Fernandez con Lucha Libre y 70 Pro.
Yes, sir, and I guarantee you whatever he said was right because I know I'm from South Texas. Right. I understood most of it.
Yeah.
I had some uncles that were down in the Alamo. But bottom line here is Joe Gomez has got a mess going with Mongo McMichael at Bash at the Beach on July the 7th. Part of the wall, hostile takeover coming. And Larry, you were like visually seeing this thing this past Monday Nitro happened with them guys with the bats and that title change and everything.
Yeah, cowardly act to come down with bats, no question about it. I think they shot their mouths off, and now that they got what they wanted, they realized maybe they really don't want it now.
Well, I think the key is who the third guy is. I guarantee you, everybody wants it, and we're getting ready to have it because the battle lines are drawn, and we're ready to go. But talking about Nitro coming up this Monday night,
right,
live on TNT too. Harlem Heat just won them in the what I call controversy. They took them things when police filled the ring, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
At the height of confusion, they took it.
Well, the Steiner brothers now going to get an opportunity to come back on Nitro this Monday night live for 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Hottest show on television.
Telling
big
you.
Big battleship sitting out there on TNT.
Yep.
And regain them title.
Hopefully Eric Bischoff will be at his usual spot in hour number two of TNT Monday Nitro. Tony Schiavone and you, legend, you'll be anchoring hour number one.
Hour number one, we also got over a ton of humanity in there, man against man, when the Giant takes on John Tenta, and all the horsemen will be there in an eight-man tag. Big, big show Monday night.
Let me mention a tag match at Bash in the Breach that absolutely intrigues me.
What is the
dog collar match. You got the Nasty Boys. You got Public Enemy. Each one of these men is going to have a dog collar around their neck attached to a chain. This is no traditional tag team match.
Well, I think everybody's taking a run at trying to go ahead and end this thing. If the war zone is there and they're in the field of battle, let's go ahead and get after it. And so much has been said about the Costa City Silver Dollar match. Silver Dollar's on a pole. First man to get it wins with Penta and Bubba, but we all go back to what this is all about at Bash at the Beach and what it means to the company and to wrestling and where we'll go from there on July the 8th when we look at three guys, two we know, one we don't, going against our three. And I think that the hostile takeover is a good name for it, brother, because as you said, they wanted it, Larry said, and they got it now.
And Sunday, July 7th, after that, professional wrestling will never be the same again.
Wow.
I heard Tony Schiavone make that statement, that this indeed could chase the
horse. Larry just made it.
Well, don't give
Schiavone credit.
Wait a minute. Let me talk to you about original lines.
Watch out.
Tony Schiavone was the first to bring up the fact that this is going to change the course of professional wrestling. All you managed to do was reflect on that very,
can I say
very
that's
important
because he talked
point.
To me before the show.
Can I interrupt this thing just a little bit?
Yes.
Manny Fernandez is stuffing a mud hole in Jose Gonzalez. Gomez here. I mean, I guarantee you.
Manny Fernandez is really taking it to the rookie. I mean, really getting after him right here. Gomez is a desperado.
Hey, Gomez could be over. Almost.
Yeah, and if he is like this against Mongo McMichael, Mongo McMichael will leave a hole in his soul as they run through him at Bash of the Beast.
But McMichael's also a rookie. I mean, he's going to be in as many Pro Bowl games as you want to.
Yeah.
This is a whole, you know, this is not a game. They don't call this a game.
Yeah.
You don't see anybody with 76 on their jersey.
Yeah, one thing, McMichael's, at least he's competed at an aggressive level. Gomez here has to get more aggressive. Both rookies in wrestling, but McMichael's experience when it comes to being aggressive in pro contact, and Gomez almost got it again.
Manny Fernandez is putting the whipping on this guy.
Don't forget, McMichael's is now under the tutelage of Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, two of the greatest around.
Well, I wanted to mention that point. You talk about McMichael and all the years he wore a Chicago Bears jersey. He put on that Four Horsemen jersey and had the same amount of pride, it seems. He is thrilled to be a member of the Four Horsemen.
Any idiot can be a Bear.
Bottom line, everybody putting on the WCW jersey, no matter what you say about it, everybody involved here putting on the WCW jersey, and we are getting ready to get on after it. These three guys, hostile takeover, Bash of the Beast, July the 7th.
Joe Gomez connecting on a powerful drop kick into a body slam, and he's going for a high-risk move. See if he can connect on Manny Fernandez. He got him. This could be it. 1, 2, and 3.
Well, he did come back.
He nailed Fernandez right across the face with that arm coming off the top turnbuckle. See if he's that lucky against Mongo.
We're going to see a whole lot more coming up at Bash at the Beach.
Staggerly Mungo is a newfound friend of the legendary disco who knocked him so bad.
He's not a friend. Just has more guts than I thought.
You guys sort it out. We're coming right back on TBS.
Good morning. Here on WCW Pro, I'm Gene Okerlund, and today during my exclusive hotline report, remember the third man theme? Huh? Some folks don't. Some do remember that. We're talking right now about a third man, these interlopers, these intruders, these outsiders, these two men, and who will their third man be at the Bash at the Beach? Plus, continued movement again in the ranks of professional wrestling. These and other stories will be the focus of my exclusive hotline report all day today. Call 1-900-909-9900. Calls are $1.49 a minute. Kids, you must get your parents' permission, but call the hotline right now. 1-900-909-9900.
A week and a day away from Bash at the Beach, and that reminds me, Los Luchadores Más Magnífico, Rey Mysterio Jr. y Psicosis. I'm telling you, boys. Well, I also speak fluent Canadian.
Well, between you and Dusty, I don't know what anybody's saying now.
You take a look at Chris Benoit, who set the tone for the Hawksman of the late 90s, going in there with the youth and experience and the attitude that he's got right now. Mongo McMichael's flair and the enforcer, what a deal came about at the Great American Bash. Talk about Mysterio Jr.
Mm-hmm.
Word on the street, the hottest product in wrestling or sports. Today, they believe a lot of the people is this young man from Mexico. So what an event that will be at the Night of the Hostile Takeover, Bash at the Beach.
If you have never seen Lucha Libre-style wrestling, you are not going to want to miss the Bash at the Beach just to see Rey Mysterio and Psicosis. As Larry has mentioned, you talk about a guy focused. There is no more intense athlete on the face of the earth right now than this man, the Canadian crippler, Chris Benoit.
What tenacious guy as he is, he's starting early. Got a big jump here, and he will not cut to a break. That's smart thing, and obviously this guy is ready to go in that ring with Arn Anderson and take on the Taskmaster and the Giant. And, of course, the Horsemen beat the Giant and the Taskmaster. One of the Horsemen will be the number one contender for the heavyweight championship of the world. And, of course, I think we all know Ric Flair is chomping at the bit.
It's going to be Arn Anderson and the Canadian crippler Chris Benoit. Tag team action against the Giant and the Taskmaster. As you said, legend, it could be a setup play for the Nature Boy Ric Flair, looking to become heavyweight champion of the world one more time. Did he make it a 14th time?
Well, he may. He surrounds himself with tough men, the enforcer Arn Anderson. Now they got Mongo McMichaels, Chris Benoit, all
in front running cover for the Nature Boy.
Wow. I'll tell you, this guy did not get the name Crippler by clipping coupons. He just laid an elbow on Butch Long that flattened him. Just flattened him.
Benoit always in control of his balance, and that's what gives him the power and the explosive nature. You need balance. Benoit always has it.
I'll give this to Butch Long. Every opportunity that this Long gets, he fires back at Benoit. And I think Benoit's starting to get a little bit miffed at it.
Well, you get frustrated when you get in a situation where people think, well, maybe you're going to put this guy away, and this guy really fights back because Butch Long is saying, hey, this is...
Oh, look, roll up. Nice move by Long. Two and... Did he get him? No, a two count. Oh, look out. He is really, this guy's got a few shorter than a Buck Private's haircut. I mean, this guy is low-tempered.
He don't want to slip up here and let Butch Long take a fall on the pro this morning on TBS.
This could be it.
That would be an embarrassment.
Go for the cover. If you're gonna do it, go for the cover.
What? He said, don't ever kick out on me again. Benoit thought he had him, obviously embarrassed. Butch Long tried to survive, but... Again, being a horseman, you don't want to take, no for an answer. You just go until you win. That's how you have to have your mindset. No doubt. 100% confidence. Oh, and Butch Long just ran into one.
Very heads-up move by the Canadian Crippler, who's not only physically intimidating, now he's putting a verbal whipping on people, Graham.
Well, you talk about the intimidation. Him, we mentioned Rey Mysterio Jr. Talk about the mothership WCW Saturday night. We will see the three guys that we have chosen to go to war at this hostile takeover at Bash at the Beach only on pay-per-view. We will also, though, get an opportunity against a good young man, Billy Kidman, where Rey Mysterio Jr. is going to hook it up with him tonight on Saturday night. Right here on TBS.
The mothership,
yes.
As it has been so aptly named by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And Long's firing back again. Ow, what a right hand. Oh, my.
I think Chris Benoit said enough of this punk. He just reached out and nailed him. Got him trapped in the corner right there. No breaks from the horsemen.
The intensity has been turned up an entire new level by the four horsemen. If you thought there was dissension within those ranks, you forget all about that. They are indeed, as they claim to be, the most elite fighting machine in all of wrestling. And I'll give you that part. They are a fighting machine to be sure. That there is the symbol of the four horsemen into a full Nelson.
Going back.
Japanese suplex. He's got him for the pin.
Well,
one, two.
He let him go.
Well, why he let him go is because he pinned his head.
Pinned his head.
Did you hear that?
Well, he says it. He means it. He is in control right now, in control of Butch Long. Could have pinned him easier. He's got a hook on him here, boys.
Look what he's got. He's got his arm barred by his legs and the reverse chin lock. This is a submission hold. And he's cranking it.
I said that. He's got him hooked here.
That's it. Submission.
Wow.
Long had a lot of fight in him.
Very impressive. But he tried, but Benoit, this guy's a machine. Great pick of the four horsemen to incorporate Benoit in their organization.
It is Chris Benoit, Arn Anderson, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, now Mungo McMichael. They make up the four horsemen. 1-800-COLLECT. Tell them what they just saw.
Well, they just seen Butch Long try to collect some teeth that Benoit removed for him. Right here, nice snap, though. Benoit bridges up, lets him go, slaps some sense into this boy to remind him that Mr. Benoit is in complete control.
That's what he said. I'm in control here. As you can see, reverse chin lock and an arm bar with his legs. The replay by 1-800-COLLECT. From anywhere to anywhere. And save yourself, watch this, save yourself mas dinero. That's Spanish. A
lot of money.
Baseball bats flying around last TNT Monday Nitro. In the confusion, Sting and Luger lost the tag team belt
in such a way.
And don't forget, we've got Saturday night here on TBS, and also still time for you great fans in Philadelphia to get your tickets for the Civic Center WCW action tonight at the Civic Center in Philadelphia. Now, we have been waiting all morning for this main event. Do you see Cheese, Chives, Chove, Cheese, isn't it?
Cheese.
leading in Squire Dave Taylor and the Earl Robert E.
Yeah, I tell you what, they're kind of shoving him around and pushing him around, and they seem to have a lot of conversation now as of late between Duke of Earl Bob and the rest of the Blue Bloods. You know what I mean? I think it's really concerning Chaz, if you will. Jeez.
I think you're right.
But well, the Earl of Eden doesn't treat Jeeves right. The man's a butler. He's supposed to do all the dirty work. He does the dishes. He permeates the wigs with hairspray.
Yes.
He takes care of all the clothes, makes the beds. He's a butler.
So what's the issue that David Taylor has? He does a good job.
We do the same thing in this country. We just call him wise.
I tell you what, you used a great word there when you said terminate. When you said terminate, I'm going back to what we've seen and what we talked about all day. Looking at this tag match coming up, our two guys are coming out here, two of them.
Oh, yeah.
But termination was on the mind of these two guys with the baseball bats on this past Monday Nitro. Make no mistake about it, brother. They were out there to terminate somebody.
Yeah, and I'll tell you, that wasn't Ruth and Gehrig making their appearance,
man,
either. Those two garboons, I can't believe that we are actually going to have to go to war. But war is what we've got, and here's two of our three guys, the total package, Lex Luger and Sting. Good opportunity for them to
Looks almost different, these guys coming out without wearing the tag team championships, without wearing the gold, but I think in terms of what has to be done July 7th, probably a blessing in disguise. Now they have nothing to focus on but the reputation of WCW.
Yeah, respect, brother.
Mm-hmm. And I think what you're going to find out in this match, gentlemen, is that both Squire Dave Taylor and also the Earl of Eaton, they wanted to represent WCW. These guys think they have as much right at Bash in the Beach as does the total package and Sting. These guys have a point to prove that they're the two toughest hombres walking the boulevard.
Hey, Sting stole the wig.
Well, they're making light of him right here. I guarantee you, it might be one of them opportunities.
Look at that. That's one of those albino raccoons.
Stop it.
Well, look at it.
Well, look at Sting right here. We'll be back.
Important phone call if you haven't already. Call your cable operator. Tell them you want Bash at the Beach Sunday, July 7th, exclusively on pay-per-view from Daytona Beach, Florida. And it's going to be an opportunity right here for both Sting and Lex Luger. Luger doing his Dolly Parton impersonation, apparently. They're getting ready for Bash at the Beach.
I haven't seen hair like that since Dusty in the 70s.
That's right. It's true. Look, he's looking a little bit like a poodle right here. But I tell you what, they're getting under the skin of the Blue Blood. They got to stay focused on what is really facing them at Bash at the Beach, July the 7th. I know the Macho Man getting together, getting it. They all put all their differences aside, all three of them. They said, we got to go out and go to battle, go to war here, because as many says, and I believe that this pay-per-view will really set the tone of what pay-per-view television is all about.
Well, I hope Macho Man put all his problems and his personal problems and his psychological problems aside. I don't want any of that interfering. There's going to be a new wrestling order, and it's going to happen July 7th.
No doubt about it. In fact, Tony Schiavone was the one who brought up the point that after July 7th, it could be literally the crossroads of professional wrestling, the turning point in professional wrestling, and we want you to be a part of it. Please call your cable operator right now. Bash at the Beach coming up. Sting, the total package, Lex Luger, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, against, well, we know who two of those garboons are. We still don't have a name for number three.
Well, I tell you what, you know, we're looking for that, and obviously they're not going to let us know who that is until Bash at the Beach. So if you're going to find out, you're going to have to watch that pay-per-view, because I guarantee you, for no other reason, is hostile takeover, assassinations attempt. All these things have happened, and it's almost to the point of time to where we got to say, okay, which we did, let's go for it. Let's duke it up, tape them up, and go.
At least we got the guts to lay all our cards on the table. I think it's kind of cowardly not laying all your cards down back.
Well, you're talking about the ultimate cowards, as we brought up earlier. They could have taken on you, Larry. They could have taken on the American Dream. Who did they choose to take on? Eric Bischoff. Come on. Come on.
Yeah, well, they were making a statement, though.
What, that they're a bunch of cowards?
A statement to WCW on what they wanted to do, and I guarantee you, it hit home hard, because everybody's riled about it. See, Duke of Earl right here, really in a world of trouble. Don't seem to really have any game plan there with Squire. Look at this. They're always talking about it.
Well, Squire was going to go in and out.
I couldn't hear what he said in the Earl of Eden, but I don't think it was very nice.
I don't think so either. If I heard what I thought I heard, it wasn't nice at all.
What did you hear?
Well, no, I mean, decorum prevents me from saying decorum. What I thought I heard.
Decorum.
Don't say decorum. Dusty will start rearranging the place.
Yeah, and putting like wallpaper stuff with cowboy stuff all over.
Well, Squire Dave Taylor now in the corner of Sting and Luger, a clean break, and I don't think Squire Dave Taylor anticipated getting out of there unscathed, but he did.
Shock, Tim, I'm surprised that Luger let him go.
I am too. Quite honestly, I am a little surprised at that, because we're talking about a couple of guys that are literally fixing their bayonets, getting ready to do battle against, well, like we said, two of those nasty guys, and the third one yet to be named. So Luger's got to start getting a serious game face about him, and I think the Blue Bloods are going to give him a heck of a test right here on the Pro.
Well, I think Luger hears what these two guys are saying. I think he realizes there's some dissension, which, you know, once a tag team has dissension within its ranks, it's easy pickings, and Squire came flying in free of charge.
Key to tag team wrestling has got to be the unity, and if the unity is being questioned among the Blue Bloods, then there is indeed a problem between Squire Dave Taylor and the Earl of Eaton. Talk about making a point. If a picture does speak a thousand words, that pose by Lex Luger speaks volumes.
Look, Squire Dave Taylor, he's a wrestler here. He doesn't want to get involved in the psychological antics of Lex Luger. I mean, Lex Luger is scary enough just standing there.
Well, it isn't a physique contest, that's for sure. And Squire Dave Taylor, as has been pointed out, one of the true rarities, a third-generation wrestler. Luger and Eaton locking it up. Eaton now turning Luger into the turnbuckle. Referee tells him to break.
Let's see if he
tells him to break and a rake
in
the eyes.
See if he can get any momentum going right here on the Pro this morning. Get Blue Bloods. Well, they'd like nothing better than to go ahead and get a win and make a statement, as you said. But Luger and Sting really need to stay focused.
They're outside of the ring now. Now they're just throwing. Is he going to toss him? He hit tosses him onto the cement. There's no mat down there, guys. That's
nothing.
Right on the cement.
Well, Luger, he's turning it on now. There you go. Throw him back in the ring. Keep thinking. That's where you can beat the man in the ring.
Eaton backing off. I don't think he wants to appease what he just bit off of, and that was the ire of the total package, Lex Luger. Luger, as you said, really getting into it now.
Yeah, but this tag team right here, these guys think together. Blue Bloods, somewhere along the line, they have got some communication problem. And Squire and the game plan is just thrown out the window, and they're really not getting it together.
You're right. There's a hatchet that needs to be buried, but these two guys are burying it in each other.
Well, I know three heads where you could bury it very nicely in. Come July 7th, you know who I'm talking about.
I know exactly who you're talking about. The interlopers, the punks. I mean, that was such a punk city move. I can't get over the fact that they went after Eric.
I wish they would have tried to throw me off.
I wish they would have, too. I wish they'd have gone after you or gone after the Dream. But no, cowards that they are, they went after Eric. And not only did they just shove him, they slammed him right through a stage, for crying out loud. Forearm by Taylor. Another forearm by Taylor. A third, and it's Taylor trying to send a message now saying, I want to represent WCW. Everybody wants a piece of that action, including the Earl of Eaton.
Yeah, they also want to move up and get those tag team championships now held by the Harlem Heat, and a victory over Sting and Luger would definitely make a number one. Uh-oh.
He get him? No.
Well, I tell you what, Steiner's got something to say about that. Coming up on this Monday night, so 2 hours live on TNT. Coming up live, Steiner's Harlem Heat going to get a shot at the World Tag Team title. Steiner's all after that situation exploded the other night into mass confusion. Mm-hmm. Where really, I didn't think anybody knew what was going on except police guys with baseball bats. The war zone had started. Everybody started running around going crazy. And Harlem Heat took advantage of that situation, probably not even knowing, looked like, what was going on. But they eased out, brother, used their head. Now they're World Tag Team Champion. And who are they talking to on the cellular phone now? They're calling 1-800-COLLECTOR somebody. Last time they did that, they were World Tag Team Champion, and now they are once again.
Ironic as it may be, in fact, they used that cellular phone, and they're wearing the gold vertical. Down goes Eaton. What a suplex by the total package, Lex Luger.
Yeah, Luger got him up there nice, dumped him nice, knocked the wind out of the Earl of Eden. Luger's close to Sting, really hasn't tagged in a while. He needs to make this.
He made the tag, but Eaton's going to a corner where nobody is. There's no partner over there, and here comes Sting.
Goes Taylor.
Yeah. Oh, face first, mouth full of canvas, and again, backhand to Squire, and working now on the Earl of Eaton, and now we've got all four men in the ring.
Well, Luger, he gets frustrated easily. He's not the legal man. He's got to get out of there.
Whip into the turnbuckle. Here comes the Stinger. Ah, the Stinger splash did not connect. Connecting only with a turnbuckle. Now, what? Guys, he's just...
I can't believe what I just seen. I just seen a squire nail Bobby Eaton on two different occasions there. It looked like on person. Person. Speaking of person, now he's got him beat right here.
Oh, look it. Wait a minute. He can't take a couple of shots from Dave Taylor, followed up by the Stinger splash. But I didn't expect anything to happen other than defeat.
I don't think Taylor meant to hit him. Sting ducked
out
of the way.
Wait a minute. I understand not meaning to hit him once. He hit him twice. And here comes your lordship, Steve Regal.
Where's the replay?
Well, Regal now concerned about it, and Squire pointed at Duke Guerrero at Bob, who's in the ring there.
Look at Eaton.
Uh-oh.
He can't imagine why they point the finger at him.
Well, I tell you what, Sting and Luger looking good. We will see them tonight with the Macho Man Randy Savage on WCW Saturday Night, the Mothership, and talk more about bashing the beach, the wall, the hostile takeover. Going to be big.
Eaton's questioning the squire. But you popped me. You popped me twice right in the mouth. Look at this. He's trying to plead his case down to Regal, and Regal pointing an accusatory finger. What is going on with the Blue Bloods?
I don't know. I can't hear him.
Well, Regal obviously trying to restore some sort of sense, some sort of calm, some sort of reason to the tag team.
See, I just heard Taylor say it now. He hit him by accident.
I'm not buying it. I'll buy the first one, but he hit him twice.
I'm not going to buy anything, but that's what he said.
There it is.
Anyway, right there, I mean, you get too many arms, too many legs in one situation. Accidents are bound to happen. Taylor doing well there. Right here, Sting got one in on the Earl of Eaton. Could be a little off. Definitely some words back and forth between the Earl of Eaton and Squire Dave Taylor earlier. And their tag team efforts, you know, were a little bit off. Telegram here, and that's unusual when you see the Earl of Eaton send one. But accident or no accidents, ooh, July 7th, Bash at the Beach. No accidents, no room for accidents, and it better not happen.
I'm Lee Marshall, along with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, the living legend, Larry Zbysko. Don't forget, we've got Saturday Night coming up on TBS and Nitro on Monday.